Chewy bread doesn't taste good with the chocolate that they put in there.
I fuck with it.
Joey, you fuck with anything.
Joey's like, is that fucking weird? I fuck with that.
Is this seasoned vomit? I mean, yeah. I'm gonna try it.
What's up, you crazy kombini cunts? Welcome back to another episode. That wasn't my idea. That was gone.
God, that you. I know you've been hanging out with Aki too much because that was the most American sounding cunt I've ever heard. Yeah, that was like the hard C.
Dude, that is like actually the most offensive thing you can say to an Australian.
POV, you're a YouTube channel waving goodbye to monetization. So what are we doing today, Jay? What's the theme of today's episode?
Yeah.
Well, the theme of today's episodes is Japanese convenience stores. I didn't just say konbini in the intro for shits and giggles. Like we're going to be talking about konbinis. As it's called in Japan, because Japan, I feel, is the only country where the word convenience in the word convenience store actually, you know, means what it means.
I think there's a lot of places in Asia where convenience stores are very convenient, but definitely as someone who's traveled around, Japan's up there.
It's just built different.
Yeah, yeah. Japan's up there. Some of the best convenience stores in the world.
Absolutely.
And you've seen all those videos of those YouTubers with the, you know, Kevin MacLeod or whatever the fuck he's called, copyright free music playing in the background, being like, these are my favorite 10 konbini snacks. That's not what we're doing today. We're going to crack open-
The konbini halls?
Yeah, the konbini. We're just going to crack open a bunch of beers, just start eating shit and just saying words. Look, that's how we do it.
Part of this is we want to represent our team because I am team 7-Eleven. He is team Lawson and he is team Family Mart.
I just think Lawson's is built different. They've just figured it out. Like Family Mart, okay, honestly, like I could 7-Eleven, I respect the choice. Family Mart, you're actually just like, you have zero choice.
I agree. Family Mart, Family Mart is the clown pick right here. 7-Eleven, we are global conglomerates. We have not just taken over Japan. We are freaking everywhere in Asia. And I'm
that's why they've been tainted by all the other countries.
And I'm going to prove why today 7-Eleven is the biggest convenience store.
There's more than these three convenience stores in Japan. There's like the smaller ones like Mini Stop, Daily Yamazaki. Yeah. I think I fuck with Daily Yamazaki.
Do you? Yeah. Everyone I know, I think I asked Chris, I'm like, do you like Daily Yamazaki? And Chris was like, nah, it's fucking
Chris up. Is the whitest man alive. What does he know?
He's like me. That's why I can trust his opinion.
So finally another Chris, white man.
I need another white British man opinion. What, is this good? No, shit. All right,
no, thanks, whenever Chris. I go to like Daily Yamazaki, one of the smaller chains, it's like going to fucking Aldi's or Iceland. Yeah, so
you never see these convenience stores. Now, if you don't know anything about convenience stores, they are pretty much found in every 100 meters.
Yeah,
literally every block of land, there's at least one convenience.
Yeah, literally when you like look into houses to rent, one of the selling points is literally the meters away from the nearest convenience store. Yeah. When you're looking at listing for houses, that's how much they care about convenience
stores. And if you live in Tokyo, they'll most 100% be like three within your vicinity.
Yeah, absolutely.
And even when you go rural areas, you're driving around, there'll be nothing. And then
there's a convenience.
You'll just see this perfect, immaculate 7-Eleven just there.
Yeah.
And it's great because it's not like a gas station where you're like, fuck. Mm. God, I gotta get those hot dogs that are probably gonna give me salmonella.
Yeah.
I'm probably not gonna like this. It's legit good food. So
we've
picked a bunch of items today that we all kind of like,
or
that we could find because sometimes the items aren't available.
We pick the items that we normally buy when we go to our convenience store of choice. And then we got our intern to buy a lot of other random shit from convenience stores just to show to you.
Go out of our comfort zone a little bit.
Yeah, going out of our comfort zone just to show you what is available at Japanese konbini.
Yeah, we definitely haven't tried all the things we're going to talk about today. So it's kind of a learning experience. Also, if you're an audio only listener, this is just going to be eating ASMR. So you should probably
tune in. This is going to be the closest to the figure episodes that we've released in a while where if you're an audio only listener, I apologize.
Yeah.
But yeah, shall we just kind of jump right into it, gentlemen?
Sure.
Now, I think I know what I want to start off with because this is the debate that I think started this episode idea, which is fried chicken.
Right. Yes.
Now, I don't care about how good the rest of the konbini food is. How I judge konbinis is the fried chicken.
Right,
when I moved to Japan, you know, we think that a lot of Americans, you know, they would like to stand their fried chicken, but a lot of the best fried chicken I've had has come from Asia. And konbini food fried chicken is way too fucking good. It should be illegal to make fried chicken taste this good.
It's like restaurant quality.
Yeah.
So, when you go to the konbini, there'll be hot food sections, right? Where you can get various amounts of hot food. But the fried chicken is like the selling point. They'll often have a whole section.
It's like
fried
probably chicken. The first thing you'll see.
Yeah.
And it normally comes in, as the gentleman will show you, comes in this little pouch like this, right?
It doesn't come in the pouch. It's on display on like a heating
but it
rack. Come,
but they put it in a pouch.
And then they put it in a pouch. And what you can do is you just rip off half half the pouch like
unless
this.
You're a Lawson and you have to open it from the top like
I don't
a
mind
man.
That. I don't mind squeezing it out. This is a Lawson fight. Look at that. Look at that, man. Is that
family,
not-
Family.
Look, convenience store points down because look how convenient
Yeah, exactly.
Is.
Look at the convenience of this.
Look at that. Look at that.
Where's the fucking seasoning on that? There's nothing on that.
Okay, I'd like to just give a huge disclaimer. I'm personally not a huge fan of the I think I'm like one in a million where I almost never buy the fried chicken at convenience stores.
Right.
Because I don't really eat fried chicken to begin with.
Now, this is the standard just pepper and salt fried chicken, but in Lawson's you can get like a ton of different variations. They have one that is like, it's like Chinese sweet and sour one and it's like black and I don't know why, it doesn't look good at all, but it's fucking amazing.
I've never tried it, but it just
Chinese
looks
sweet and sour. I know.
It's a literal black chicken, and it looks like someone it's like someone took a chicken and just dunked it in squid oil. That's what it looks like.
What I think we should do is we should cut up three pieces. Sure. We should trade pieces.
Okay.
We should trade pieces.
Okay. Fuck,
my hands are greasy. Can we get like napkins galore? By the way.
Okay, I'm gonna take the knife and then I'm gonna cut up three pieces.
Yeah, mine as well,
now, right. Here's the thing: these chicken right now, they're not gonna look at peak condition because we had to microwave these. Normally, they're crispy. Yeah. They're nice and crispy.
Yeah, they come in fresh out and hot.
Fresh out the oven.
Yeah, I just cut two pieces so you guys can take, and I'll just take
fantastic.
This.
Okay.
Fan-fucking-tastic.
There we go, that's two pieces of you boys. Okay. And also, if you're not really into like a whole breast, that's fine, because a lot of them also have like the like nuggets, like substitute.
Thank you.
All right, here, I'm gonna hand these over to you.
Right, okay, let's give it a shot.
All right, let's-
This is like the Last Supper, but Family Mart edition.
We're not sharing the bread, we're sharing the chicken.
Joey, if you will, do me the honor.
Okay.
Grab
one of these.
Right, I'll try it. Should we try the Family Mart chicken first?
Okay, let's go bottom up.
Let's start with Family Mart.
You know what, the crispiness, it looks good. The color looks good. I'm down for it. That was, it's very wet though. Look at the grease that is left on my plate.
There is a lot of grease in Family
Mart. Out of all of these, like the Family Mart one has almost left the puddle.
This is actually like kind of, I'm gonna eat it.
Yeah, you can tell this is Family Mart chicken because it's like compared to the 7 chicken, this one can't be white because it's gonna stain the white one.
It's just gonna go straight through.
It's gonna go straight through. So I'm gonna.
It is very fatty and very greasy. Like I feel like there's no breast. Mm. You know what I mean? It's not good. Obviously, if you know, I'm in the middle of nowhere, I'm in Hokkaido, I want a beer and a fried chicken, it's gonna do the job. But when there's Lawson's and you know, 7-Eleven.
Again, I will happily take this over because I don't even eat fried chicken to begin with.
Yeah, okay, my problem with Family Mart fried chicken is that it tastes like death. You know, sometimes when you're eating and you realize, wait a minute, I'm eating a dead animal right now. That is what Family Mart chicken tastes like.
It feels like they inject it with stuff as well.
I feel like that too, yeah.
Let's try the 7-Eleven one there, shall we?
Okay.
Which one's the 7-Eleven one?
It'll be this one, this color.
This slightly orange one.
Yeah.
Now,
it's pretty good.
The reason I stand 7-Eleven and the reason it's my favorite one is because of their fried chicken.
This one's also quite fatty though.
It's fatty enough where it's less than the Family Mart chicken. It's the perfect amount. You know when you want a beer and you just want to eat something unhealthy? This is the perfect amount of oil and unhealthiness that doesn't make you feel like you're eating death. It still makes you feel like you're eating like something that you shouldn't be enjoying every day. Yeah.
I have to say, I think in terms of the seasoning,
they seasoned the fuck out of that.
It's
that
way was, better than the Family Mart.
I think out of all of them, this like with Lawson's, they have way more choice in the chicken seasoning. Mm. Like there's like the spicy.
Yeah, I think this is gonna be the weakest one out of like the choices that Lawson's have. Yeah. I'm not trying to like, you know, bat myself in a corner, but like, I'm just saying.
Like out of everything, 7-Eleven just does the basic fried chicken the best. Has the best seasoning. Doesn't need anything fancy. No spicy chicken. It's just pure. Here's what fried chicken should taste like: salt and pepper, seasoned perfectly, the right amount of oil. It is the best fried chicken.
Okay, let's try this Lawson one because I've realized immediately that in terms of the thickness of chicken, this is probably the thickest.
It's a thick boy.
Yeah,
you're getting good chicken.
That's like a proper amount of chicken.
This is a proper amount of here's the chicken and here's the-
That could be a tendy, dude. That's so good.
Yeah, exactly.
It honestly tastes like a tendy as well.
For the right amount of juicy.
Actually, you know what? I think that might be my favorite.
Right?
It tastes more like a chicken tender than a breast.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm.
Well, it tastes like the closest to KFC for some reason. You know what I mean?
I agree.
I think it needs more seasoning.
This is what I mean. Like take that chicken, right? And actually put like a fuck ton of seasoning on it, make it spicy.
Because
it's the best.
That's the reason I stand the 7-Eleven chicken. It is, It is like, I'd say there's less fat than the 7-Eleven chicken, but the 7-Eleven chicken just has the best seasoning. Mm. And why do we eat fried chicken? It's because of the seasoning. Like, you know, why
the 11 secret herbs and spices.
Like imagine buying KFC chicken and then all the skin's off. No one would want to eat that shit. Let's be honest. You eat it because of the skin, because of the seasoning on the fried chicken. Mm. So I will go, you know, I will fight you on this.
So let's rate 1, 2, 3. I personally would say Lawson 7-Eleven Family Mart.
I'd say the same for me personally. I'm biased, I'd say,
you two are a little more biased.
Yeah. I'd say 7-Eleven, Lawson's, Family Mart, right at the bottom.
Well,
yeah.
we can all agree
that Family Mart's at the bottom in this case.
As the third opinion in the room, Joey, I suppose you've put it over the edge for Lawson's.
I would have to give a point to Lawson. Just because, though, the seasoning for 7-Eleven is good, but I think it's like too much seasoning for me.
Yeah. They also do nuggets. Now these are the basic kind, which I you'd never catch me finding. I don't go for the basic. I want spice. There's a hot version and I think there's a cheese version.
Yeah.
I don't fuck with the cheese versions because it's like injected cheese. I don't trust that. Cheese should be on top. It should never be injected.
Right.
There's some things that should be injected. Cheese isn't one of them.
Vaccines, like, check.
Yeah. Medicine, check.
And these have been microwaved because we've heated them up, but it doesn't look too great. Not gonna lie. You guys want to try a nugget?
Yeah.
The color on this chicken is kind of tragic looking, honestly. I did eat one before recording, so I was getting really hungry.
This looks actually, this is the most depressing chicken nugget I've ever seen.
You know what this looks
seen.
Like? This looks like this is like frozen.
Yeah, look how yellow this is.
Like it was once frozen and I just defrosted it.
It's like, it lacks any kind of color that would make it look appealing.
Oh no.
That ain't good.
No.
They had a slam dunk.
Lawson, 7-Eleven, Family Mart, and then whatever the fuck I just ate.
Okay, that was worse than the Family Mart chicken that we just had.
Yeah.
God, I said the awful. Family Mart chicken tasted like death. Oh my God. Mm. This tastes
right out the freezer.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Okay, you know what this tastes like? This tastes like-
Can you stab it and show it to the camera?
Okay.
Look at that. This for real tastes like-
The skin is like dying to get off it.
This is like one of those karages you order at a really, really cheap izakaya.
Yeah. It's like 50 yen fried
50
chicken.
50 yen for one, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that ain't it, chief.
Man, the fried, but I mean, honestly, you can't really go wrong unless you go Family Mart.
I would say the reason that, I mean, so where we live right now, we live right next to a Family Mart and we live right next to a Lawson's. Unfortunately, we don't live next to a 7-Eleven. No. And that's a shame for me because some of my best food items, like the fried chicken and like some of the other things I'm going to show off today, is from 7-Eleven.
Yeah. That's why like every time you see a 7-Eleven, it's like an event. Right?
Yeah. Definitely.
It's like a random encounter.
Dude, I'm like, I can get the fried chicken right now. I'll be right back.
I just had lunch, but vinegar and fried chicken.
Be right back, boys.
They also have a bunch of, it's not just these. They have tons of other hot food items. They have like, it's like a pita bread with like fillings, like folded up and then they microwave it.
Well, and the other one they have right here. Well, no, the one I have here is like a kushi, like a skewered meat.
Oh, I have that as well.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah.
So these are like the snack ones. They have like meat.
Again,
pseudo-meals.
I don't think I've ever ordered these before, but they look like that.
That just looks like a yakiniku.
Yeah.
I have never ordered.
It's yakitori.
Oh, sorry, yakitori. Yeah.
I have never ordered this.
I've never ordered this either.
Should we get some of that off?
I don't have a yakitori.
You don't? Well, you can try some of mine.
Yeah, you can try some of mine here.
Honestly, these don't look like, you look at these on camera and they don't look any different from each other at all. I couldn't tell which one the Lawson's yakitori is, and I can't tell which one is the Family Mart yakitori. I've never gotten the yakitori, which is like skewered, like, barbecued skewered meats, right?
Do you feel like I'm playing with fire? You know what I mean?
Because these, both of these, the color of them,
look awful.
The coloring, just, there is no coloring at all.
Don't go to any kind of convenience store to get yakitori. There's plenty of amazing yakitori restaurants all over Tokyo. Yeah.
It's so cheap as well. Normally that you can buy per skewer.
Yeah. It's like, you know, some of the cheaper places are like 30 yen a skewer.
I'll try the Family Mart one first.
Okay, let's try the Family Mart one.
That's awful.
That is so bad. That is bad. Okay.
I think this has to be fresh because we microwave these.
Yeah.
Yeah. This, what this tastes like is they didn't know how to flavor this. So they just put as much salt on this as possible.
Yeah, this is salted like fucking
this
crazy.
Is salt and oil. What I'm tasting right now is just very salty oil.
I just stabbed into the Lawson and it like squirted oil.
Really?
Like straight up squirted oil.
All right, let me try the Lawson one. Let me try the Lawson's one.
Hmm.
They're just both as bad as each other.
Yeah, they're not that good.
Yeah,
it's pretty fun.
Bottom line, don't go to a convenience store to get yakitori. Lots of amazing izakayas and restaurants to go to for that. You all right, guys?
Yeah. I'm trying to chew this and swallow this.
I feel like we need a drink to go along with this amazing food.
Ashley, get us a drink.
Yes, sir.
Have we talked about Ashley before on this podcast?
We talked about him on the live stream.
Live stream that we did. But we now have a intern. We hired our new intern, Ashley. What he did was he sent a full CV to us. What did you get, Ashley?
No, I want an actual
Ashley! What?
Do you actually have a beer so I can wash this down? Sorry, I don't have-
Oh no.
At least he did us a favor and got the mini ones.
Do you want to explain what this is, Joe?
Okay, so this is Ozeki's one cup sake, which is essentially the like trailer trash level of sake that you can get at convenience stores.
Imagine if Budweiser tried to make a cheap version of Budweiser and this is what you would
this
get.
This is the blue lightning of sake. Right? So how much does one of these cost? These cost like $1 a pop, right?
It's like 100 yen, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. 250. Okay, 250 yen a pop.
That's too much for this.
Yeah. So this costs about $2. It's literally a jar of sake.
And we all know how much I love sake.
Yeah.
From the episode with Chris.
Honestly, none of us have tried this, right?
I've never tried this either. So I'm not even a big fan of sake in the first place.
I like
place.
Sake, but it's like wine, right? Like I need the right food for it. And this is not the right food for it.
If you calculate the price per milliliter. Mm. This is actually more expensive than the one Chris brought us. So,
could- Is that actually?
If it's 250 yen, yeah, pretty well.
Oh yeah, probably.
So Chris, you fucking cheap mother. No, I'm kidding.
Well, it doesn't smell horrible.
Well, it's sake, it never smells of anything much.
It doesn't smell too bad.
I mean, it smells like sake. What does bad sake smell like?
A bad sake will smell sour. Like you'll know.
That's like having milk and being like, this smells sour.
Legit, like.
You want to throw this away?
Yeah. Okay. Legit, yeah. Like I've had bad sake before and it's sour. It's like sour milk, but yeah, like right. Sake, it's horrible. All right, well, I guess we gotta try this, huh?
So should you all do it at the same time?
Yeah. Cheers, gentlemen. Okay.
A successful podcast, I hope.
Yes.
All right, let's give it a shot, shall we? Oh God.
That's actually not
That's
bad.
That's not bad.
That's not bad at all,
what?
Actually.
What? I was expecting a burn or a bad aftertaste. That's not bad.
You know what? I can't believe I'm saying this. I'm kind of fucking with this. Like, it actually tastes all right.
You want mine? You want mine? Nah, I don't fuck with that.
This man just cannot drink sake. This is actually, I was expecting it to feel like I'm drinking petrol.
But. Yeah, that's what I was expecting as well. Damn, Japan. This is the cheap alternative to like getting pissed in Japan.
I can see why all these like, you know, like old people go into a, you know, 7-Eleven or wherever, buy one of these and just chill at the front of a 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Like I would probably be there as well.
Honestly, this is why we like, this is why convenience are great, because sometimes you buy something and it's way better than you expect to buy at a convenience store. This sake tastes way too good for something that just came out of a 250 yen convenience store sake.
It's okay.
It's actually not bad. Wow.
It doesn't really taste of much.
That's what I mean. It's easy to drink.
Yeah, yeah. It's really easy to drink.
Because a lot of like cheap sake usually has like a very harsh flavor.
Honestly, it's less, I think it's less offensive than the one that Chris bought the other day.
This actually tastes better than the one that Chris bought.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So well, Chris fucked us over. Thanks, Chris.
I'm still going
to
stick
to
my
saying. It's the milliliter to price ratio. But go on, you have two more hot food items.
I do. I don't know what Ashley has bought me. But let's have a look. Okay, so the first one looks like a korokke.
What the?
Which, looks like a potato?
Yeah, so what a korokke is, it's kind of just like a potato katsu, right? Mm. That's the right way to describe it. So sometimes, that is very
that's
oily.
An oily boy.
That is a very oily boy. Look at that.
Do we have more plates?
Jesus Christ.
This is literally, oh my God.
Bro, you're going to get the desk all oily.
That is literally see-through. That is a see-through.
That is like the Simpsons episode.
Yeah, this is the Simpsons episode right here. So what this is, I don't know what kind of korokke this is.
Sure you want to crack that open on the table?
Yeah, it's all right.
Let's do it. Oh, okay. It's not a korokke. What is
this? Oh, it's minch katsu.
Okay, so it's not a korokke, it's katsu.
It's like minced meat katsu, basically.
Okay, I've never had this
before.
So
essentially, you know what this is? This is literally a deep fried hamburger. This is what this is. This is literally what this is. It's a deep fried hamburger.
This is, look at that. This is basically a hamburger.
It doesn't smell bad. You know what it smells like? It reminds me of like pies in the UK.
It does, a little bit.
It's like a mince pie.
It has a very pie smell. Oh my God. I don't know if you can see this on camera, but the oil has
disgusting.
The oil has seeped through to the table.
It doesn't really taste of anything. Like meat and grease. That's all I taste. There's like no seasoning.
Oh my God. This tastes Like, how do you don't know. How do you eat something and just have zero opinion about the taste?
This tastes of nothing.
This literally tastes like cardboard. Because there's no taste in it at all. Like you'd expect some kind of the burger to have some kind of seasoning on it. This tastes like batter.
Yeah.
Granted, I've had really good mench katsu, and this is definitely
weak sauce.
Like then. Weak sauce compared to what I have.
What else did you get, Con?
I got okay. Nerd, this okay. Is... Do you want to see this?
Yeah, sure.
It's a spring roll.
You ever all gotten a spring roll from?
Oh, oh my god! Look at that! This I do not stand this. Look at that. Okay, I'm gonna cut this up. You know what this is?
You know it's not good when you're cutting a spring roll and it turns flat.
It's a soggy spring roll, right?
You know? Oh. Wow.
I don't like spring rolls in general. I don't like spring rolls. They're way too oily for me.
That's not bad.
Actually, that's not bad at all.
Is it? Mm. How's it taste?
It's quite fatty somehow. Like
it
oily.
Is very fatty. You know what? It's like, it tastes like a dim sum.
Yeah, yeah. A little bit.
It's like the like kind a, of like oiliness. A really bad one? It's like an oiliness of a dim sum.
It's yeah, like, you know how, that, you know when you, because in the UK we have these like party platter things, right? Yeah. That you get from Iceland.
That's what it looked like.
Yeah, so you thought you were just going to get a bite of just pure like, just pastry. Whatever, was it pastry? Is that what it is?
Oh yeah, I think it's pastry.
Pastry,
yeah.
And then just maybe like a crumb of meat.
Yeah.
And like, that's normally how it is. That's why I hate spring rolls, but that-
That sure. One was packed.
I'd get that.
I would actually, honestly, I
did not expect it to taste that good.
Yeah. Mm.
It tastes like, yeah, like you said, like a mini dim sum.
Yeah.
But in a spring roll pastry.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. That was not the taste I was expecting.
I thought they would somehow make this one work and fuck up the spring roll.
Yeah, right?
But it was the opposite way around.
You surprise us.
But there's tons of stuff that we don't have here, the hot foods. Like it changes all the time. Like for example, Lawson's has like hot dogs that have like different toppings, like salsa, there's like meat.
I mean, let's
toppings.
Not forget as well about like the Nikumans and the pizza muns and stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I think all of the convenience stores have those.
Yeah, yeah. Nikuman, what's it called? Just like a steamed bun?
Yeah, steamed
bun. So like you can get like the Chinese steamed meat buns.
Cinnamon, all the animes.
Yeah.
Honestly, all of the meat buns in all three of the combinis are lit.
And they taste really good. They taste really good.
And those are really good. I fuck with the hot dogs. Hot dogs are pretty fucking good.
Of course.
What are they called? The goo dogs?
Goo dogs, they're called. And at one point, so they also go through, at all the chains, they all go through seasonal items.
Mm.
One point they had mini burritos.
Mini burritos?
Yeah, like microwavable burritos that were like, the size of that spring roll.
Like proper burritos?
No.
if there's one food item that I think is really hard to get in Japan or one food
Mexican
cuisine,
food, yeah.
Mexican food. It's so hard to get good Mexican food in Japan. You can get any other food. I feel like I've gone to a restaurant and I've been like, yeah, this is almost as good.
The only way you can get Mexican food is to go to like international chains that just happen to be here, right?
Yeah, yeah. And even then, like we've been to some Mexican restaurants.
My bite so we can get rid of this shit.
We've been to some Mexican restaurants and I've always felt underwhelmed.
Oh yeah,
it's always felt like the Mexican.
But it's sad because that's the best you're gonna get.
Yeah,
right?
exactly. We need more good Mexican in Japan. I'm putting that out there right now because Mexican food fucking slaps.
I get really sad because I watch on like YouTube. I watch like those like Food Insider or whatever the fuck they're called, like videos.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
The 10 best burritos in LA, and I'm like, oh my god, all of them look fucking amazing. But yeah, no, I mean, there's other food items as well that are hot. Like you can get actual like full meals. You can get instant ramen, which is like, it's like a solid, like frozen broth. I'm not really sure. It's a block. It's like
freeze dried.
It's a freeze dried block. And it basically, when you microwave it, it melts and makes a broth. That's actually like better than most of the shit you'll get ever in like America.
Oh, yeah. Hands down, yeah.
You know, even like some restaurants I've been to that say ramen. They're like, definitely not ramen.
It's definitely not ramen, yeah.
It's like actually not bad. There's also, you can get, I think Garnt has one of them with us. So there's a bunch of variations. Lawson's does a ton of like, I mean, there's the pastas as well, I remember as well.
Yeah, the pastas are lit.
Pastas, weird combinations of pastas as well. Like stuff that like you would never see ever.
Very,
in
very Japanese twist on Italian food.
What's a weird combination they have? They'll have like, fucking like egg and tomato sauce or something that like I've like
swear. Yeah, something
they put
like
hot
that.
Dogs in their pasta. Some of the pastas
they put hot
as
dogs
well.
And like,
yeah, like sausages in their pasta.
Yeah, yeah, sausage, yeah, tomato sauce, yeah, and spaghetti. Sauce, like, and it's like, okay.
Yeah. No. Some of the pastas literally look like a kid's meal.
It's true.
They look like the dairy meal lunch pack, lunchables or something like that. Well, you know when you get, you're a kid and you kind of make your own sandwich out of the lunchables.
Yeah.
That's what that's like the equivalent of putting it into Japanese, Italian cuisine.
Yeah.
Lawson's has like a premium hot food section, which is doesn't include any of that pasta shit.
Right.
It's only Japanese and not normally fried food.
Yeah.
But there is gyudon and budon? Budon?
Gyudon.
Butadon.
Butadon, that's what it is, yeah. Butadon and gyudon, which is like, gyudon is just like, I guess, strips of beef and then grilled and then put with rice. And you normally get like a sauce or a mayo to dip it in and put it in the rice.
Right.
And then butadon, which is my favorite, is just pork, like strips of pork.
Pork on some rice.
It's a pork ball or a beef ball. We're about to show you.
This episode is sponsored by Harry's.
Too often we're choosing between quality or a fair price. With Harry's, you don't have to choose, gentlemen. They give you award-winning blades at factory direct prices.
They give us both quality and fair price?
I thought that was illegal.
I thought that was illegal as well.
Now, I have to ask, boys, when you got your first Harry's razor set and shaved with it, what surprised you most about the quality of the product?
Well, for one, it comes in a lovely cardboard box. And look at the packaging on this.
That is sexy.
This looks clean as fuck. Look at that.
God damn.
What do you got there in your hand?
I have here the body wash, which Maylin literally said earlier, and I quote, "If you're lonely, you can know what a boyfriend smells like."
I mean, they're literally giving life to dreams. For a limited time, Harry's is offering their starter set plus a free body wash for just $3. Okay, that's actually pretty nice.
$3?
$3 at harrys.com/trashtape.
You can see us live reacting to this as we're reading.
That is literally the first time I've read that. That's actually funny.
Is it actually $3?
It's actually $3.
That's actually really good.
That is really our genuine reaction. And that comes with the shave cream, a razor with a very nice handle, by the way. We also have two razor heads, so when the first one runs out, and I don't know what that final thing, it's a storage thing for your razor. Yes. That's cute. And did you know that Harry delivers a close but comfortable shave at a fair price? Only $2 a refill, gentlemen.
That is really fucking good. For what you're getting? Oh my God.
Harry believes in quality so much that they bought their own factory in Germany so they could own every step of the manufacturing process.
Now that's an epic gamer move.
I mean, it's German, so you know they're getting shit done.
But I'm sitting here and I'm wondering, how do they do it, Gon?
Harry's team combined a simple ergonomic design with 5 sharp blades. They source their steel from Sweden and manufacture their blades in their world-class blade factory.
Harry's German factory is one of the few selected manufacturers in the world that have mastered the technology to create a Gothic arch, the gold standard for razor blade grinders.
And they have a 100% quality guarantee. They stand behind the quality of their blades so much that they have a 100% money-back guarantee on harrys.com.
So, for a limited time, Harry's has an exclusive offer for the listeners of this show. New customers can get the Harry's starter set and a free body wash for just $3 at harrys.com/trashtaste. That's over $16 of value for just $3. And you'll get a 5-blade razor with a weighted handle. It's actually quite weighty. Feel that, gentlemen. Foaming shave gel, a travel cover, and a travel-size body wash. And I have to say, I have used the razor myself. It's a very clean shave. I highly recommend it. That Gothic arch is working wonders, might I say.
It's that German engineering, right?
It's an incredibly great deal, but act fast while supplies last. Go to harrys.com/trashtaste to redeem your offer. Back to the episode.
Okay, so as the gyudon that Connor was talking about, I have some 7-Eleven gyudon right here. So
not gonna lie, it doesn't look appetizing.
I have also never seen that before.
Have you never seen this before? Honestly, it fucking slaps. It tastes great.
Show it vertically to the camera.
Okay, I can't show it vertically because it's got sauces in it. But look, what happens is that it comes with two compartments. Right, okay, there we go. I just hope none of the sauce.
There's
a lot of juices in here. So what happens is it's basically just grilled, like what is it? Grilled beef.
Yep.
Beef strips in whatever juices they cook it in. And it comes with two compartments. That is hot.
Comes with a rice compartment.
That's a common mistake that people make.
And
you can just dump it all on, or you can just like take a piece at a time.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever works best.
You got two compartments, you can eat it however you like. I like to dump it.
I'll give it
on.
A shot.
The reason why they split it up is so that-
put some spices on this bitch as well. Some like heat.
This is
heat
just
mix.
An excuse for us to film our eating our dinners, right?
Yeah. Although, not gonna lie, you can tell this is like super cheap because like this beef is half just fat. Look at that. Like that is.
You know the reason though why they split it up into two layers?
That's the good part.
You know the reason why they split it up into two layers though?
Why?
So that the rice doesn't sog up.
Yeah, obviously. You wouldn't want the rice being soggy, Jay. Come on.
Okay, honestly, if you come to Japan, try the beef bowls because the beef bowls are by far my favorite, like 7-Eleven or whatever convenience you decide.
Or I mean, you could go to the top three beef ball chains.
Or you could just go outside. There'll probably be a Matsuya Sukiya
Yoshinoya
outside.
Look at that. It's my favorite cheap Japanese dish. Yo,
throw some of that on my plate, go on.
Yeah.
So do you get this often?
I get this whenever like I'm traveling and I just, you can never go wrong with beef ball.
If I have to get a meal, in Lawson's, right, they basically do like a katsudon and they have like, it's really fucking good, really clean katsudon with just rice. It's just like perfect. It's so good. And they give you like a fuck ton as well. So good. Fuck, God, you probably piled that on there.
I don't know. I just you do like gyudon. You will be the final judge of this because you love your beef balls. You love your gyudons.
I eat probably by far the most beef balls.
Out of the three of us.
Gotta get the right ratio. Okay. I do actually like mayo with mine.
You like mayo?
Because some of the chains will give you mayo, and sometimes it's so nice to have mayo with it. I know some people think that's disgusting, but it really like, because sometimes all you're getting is just grease, and mayo helps like.
I always get mine with mayo.
Yeah, mayo.
I mean,
good.
I like the fats. I like.
Yeah, but sometimes you need to like mellow it out a little bit, you know?
Yeah, but this man doesn't like condiments, so there's no use talking to him.
Wow, that's not bad actually.
Yeah.
It's good, right?
And how much is this?
This is 400 yen.
$4.
This is literally, this is about $4 and you can get an entire meal. And it fucking slaps.
For like a one-off, it's pretty fucking good.
Yeah.
Like, if you're desperate and you want a good meal, that's actually not bad. Yeah. I'm pretty surprised.
If the gyudon man says so, then it must be good.
It is.
Obviously, you know, if you go to Matsuya, Yoshinoya or whatever, they literally cook it in front of you.
Yeah.
Like from fresh.
Yeah, honestly, like this is like. But
this is not bad.
If you're out and about and you just want a quick meal and you there's no Matsuya or there's no like chain around you. Mm. Look, he's going on for seconds. That's how good it is.
That says more than anything.
A little fatty, but yeah, it's pretty actually, I'd eat this.
Would it be good for with some mayonnaise on it?
Yeah. Bit of mayonnaise and dumpling.
Yeah.
That's not bad though.
Well, there you go. Yeah. Points to 7-Eleven for that one, I guess.
Yeah, so there is tons of other hot food that we couldn't get, and also we just don't wanna waste all of it. We don't wanna throw away too much food.
The staff is eating all of it, don't worry.
So yeah, I mean, that's most of the hot food that we wanna talk about today.
Yeah.
And the rest is just a bunch of snacks.
Yeah, if there's one thing that all three convenience stores have, it's snacks.
Yeah.
They have way more snacks than they do hot food, I think.
Oh, way, way more.
All right, so before we move on from the hot foods, so how long do you guys feel like you can survive on convenience store food before you start to get bored of it?
Well, I actually tried that out once when I was-
Why?
Because it was the only option I had. So basically when I was-
What do you mean it was the only option you had?
Well, let me explain. When I was working, I was like 16, I was working at the ski fields in Hokkaido, right?
Right.
I'm in the middle of fucking nowhere in Hokkaido, in the mountains. The only thing they had, I'm 16 as well, so I can't drive to the next-
And you can't afford a fancy meal every time.
I can't afford fancy. Basically, I'm living day by day with what they're paying me, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And also because it's snowing fucking 24/7 there, right? Without a car, you're basically fucked. Like you can't walk in, you know, into a snowstorm to like go to the next town.
Not
right?
even exactly. your financial advisor could save
Not even my financial advisor could save me. But so the only thing they had around where I was staying was a Family Mart.
Oh, that's why you're a Family Mart stan.
I literally throughout that entire month, I would want to say minimum two meals a day, every day for a month was Family Mart.
Yeah.
And you know what? I felt like I wanted to die by the end of it. There's only so much, like first week, you're just like, all right, I'm gonna try that bento. Basically, I fully completed the Pokedex of like Family Mart food, right?
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, I tried everything. And once I did finish everything, I was like, I highly regret that I did that because I feel so fucking unhealthy right now.
Because the thing is, when you come to Japan for the first time and you see how much choice of meals there are in every convenience stores, especially for me, coming from England, where the only choice I have is the Tesco's meal deal.
Hey, don't talk ill of like the best thing that we have about our country.
But there's, in terms of like, let's say packageable lunches or meals that you can get away with.
Lunchables?
Not even lunchables.
That's all I think of.
Yeah. Pastries? That's kind of about it, really. We do have some
decent- You got sandwiches, you got-
I think we all have, the problem with the UK stuff that you can like kind of take quickly, it's all in like the same genre
and
food. There's no variety.
Yeah, yeah. And the thing is only like the big super mega stores have the hot food, like the fresh chickens.
Hot food is good.
Like sometimes you go to like Sainsbury's, it's the big Sainsbury's and they have like the hot rotisserie chickens. Those actually slap, but
Tesco's have like the sausage, foot long sausage that you can eat. Fucking amazing.
But those, those are limited to like the really, really big stores. Mm-hmm. So the good thing about convenience stores is that all this, like everything you see, is basically homogenous throughout basically every convenience store you can find. Mm. There are some that are bigger that have even more choice of what you can buy, but we are showcasing stuff that you can buy in basically every convenience store you can get in.
I do think when you, after living here, it's sort of like you view convenience food almost like McDonald's in my mind. Like it starts to have like a almost McDonald's characteristic to the taste of how you know it's not like, it's not all fresh. It doesn't all taste quite like, something's been a little too
it's
like
It's not as
manufactured.
Healthy as they package it out.
To yeah.
Be. Right, I mean, there are definitely some healthy things. Like there's some decent salads, there's some stuff like that. And like, I mean, after the gym, I think we always just get like, there's just chicken breasts.
Salad chicken.
Yeah, so they have literally-
You have one of them, right?
Do I have a chicken breast?
Joey might have one.
Did you buy a chicken breast?
The only thing I have is this sausage.
No. it's just a sausage.
It's from Johnsonville. Amazing name for a sausage.
It's an American brand.
I think so.
And you can just rip it open and just start eating it,
it's
right?
It's one sausage.
What I do have, it's not a chicken breast. That's
it. Something similar like that.
But they literally have, this is a salad chicken bar. I don't know what a salad chicken bar is.
What the fuck is that?
It's like a salad in a bar with chicken.
What is that shape, bro? No chicken has ever been in that shape. What is that?
Like, it's like a chicken sausage almost.
So normally the ones that I get, and they also have them at Family Mart and Lawson, so I don't know why they wouldn't have them at 7-Eleven. They probably do.
Basically, it's like a salad chicken nugget.
Imagine literally a chicken breast seasoned. I think the one that I always go for is tandoori flavored.
Yeah, the tandoori one.
Chicken tandoori. It's literally just a chicken breast just in a vacuum sealed package that is just been
the
cooked
vacuum
and you
seal. Vacuum seal package like this.
Yeah. You crack that bad boy open at like 3 a.m.
Yeah,
and it's
you go for a workout, right? You know, you want to get some protein. What's the best source of protein? Just eat a fucking whole chicken breast.
Yeah.
20 grams of protein. Boom, you're talking.
Because normally like it makes it so convenient because no matter what mood or no matter what kind of food you want, they probably have it at your convenience store. If you want something healthy, you can.
Oh God, that looks awful.
That
looks great. Oh, show the gloss to the camera.
Oh my God, look at that.
Yo, give me a bite of that. Let's cut that out.
This is glossier than some nails. Jesus Christ.
That looks vile.
Yeah, let me try that.
Where's the knife?
Ashley, get us a knife.
Okay, go ahead.
Give me one of those.
Oh yeah, okay.
Oh, this feels, you know what this, it feels plastic.
I'll try it, but I'm not gonna like it.
This looks like a hot dog with extra peppers on it, honestly.
Oh my God, it tastes like a chicken hot dog. That's fucking weird. Yeah.
Okay, that's just a chicken hot dog.
I don't know if you were supposed to take the skin off of those, though.
No.
It's a chicken hot dog. Mm. I like how they call it a salad chicken when it's just a chicken hot dog.
Well, Japan's not going to know what a chicken hot dog is, probably.
That's fucking awful.
Yeah, do you know what they call corn dogs here?
Yeah, American dogs.
America dogs.
I mean, honestly, that's a pretty fucking good name.
Yeah, it's pretty accurate name.
It's like, what are the hot dogs that they eat in America? Corn dogs.
All right, gentlemen. We all have sandwiches from our respective stores. Yeah. And I want to know which sandwich is your go-to.
For me, it's always this one. Tuna and tamago.
Oh fuck, my bag got crushed. But honestly, I'm not making this look appetizing, but same, Joey.
Yeah.
You'll notice though, the difference between the Family Mart and Lawson sandwiches, especially with the egg.
Yeah, the egg in Family Mart, it kind of like-
sliced of egg.
Yeah, they slice the eggs. Whereas Lawson is just fully scrambled.
And honestly, yo, this shit slaps. This shit is insane.
Honestly, both of them slap, I feel. And what the fuck is going on?
They didn't have the sandwich they asked for, which is just like a katsu sando. So a katsu sando is literally just like a pork katsu, just with some bread slapped on the side and some katsu sauce.
What the fuck is, I've always seen, so this is, just show it to the camera. So I've always seen this, right? You put it in frame with us so that it's in. Okay.
It's literally like a strawberry shortcake turned into a sandwich.
That looks awful. Can you crack that open?
Okay.
I've always seen those because they sell those at Family Mart too. Yeah. I've never tried them.
Also, the genius Japanese packaging. There's just a little slip that you pull open and boom, it's ready to go.
Everything
and it folds outwards like that. Isn't that amazing? That's just beautiful.
That is Japanese engineering to the finest
and boom,
level.
You've got a little picnic for your sandwiches.
How do you feel about the lack of crust, boys?
Disgusting. It's disappointing. I mean, look at this, right? Like there's something missing. It's the bite of the crust.
Yeah.
It's not good.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Do you guys give a shit if I just rip some off and hand it to you?
Yeah, I'm just sure you. Okay.
So you try that egg gone. That's the real egg.
Okay.
That's the best. Look at the color. Look at the fucking bright. The saturation has been pumped to 10,000 on that. You know that shit's gonna taste good.
This one's got some slices in it.
I've had this one. Oh, that feels like a weak bread. You know what I mean?
They're all weak bread. Shit, what are you talking about?
Oh God, it's been dunked in the grease.
Okay. I don't know how to properly share this.
Oh, it's cross-contaminated. Oh, no!
which tamago are we trying first?
Let's try the family one first. Okay.
So the...
It's on the bottom. It's one with the slices on it.
Honestly, like, what I love about Japanese eggs is that they just have the color in them. Mm. I don't know. Every Japanese egg just is like... It's like they took the egg yolk, put it in Photoshop, and turned up the saturation. It looks beautiful.
Way too yellow for it to be real.
Yeah, I like the egg. Mm. The problem I have with this sandwich, sorry, I'm eating with my mouth, is the tuna tastes like shit.
You think so?
And this sandwich, I think
the tuna tastes the same.
No, you see what I mean, girl.
Honestly, I really like the egg. I like the egg to be solid. Mm.
I love the egg slices.
Yeah.
I do like that.
All right, let's try the Lawson egg sandwich then. So this one is no egg slices, just fully mashed.
Okay, what I don't like about this one and why I've never bought this one is because this egg looks like runny yolk.
It's good. Try it.
It looks like the shit that comes out your nose. Mm. It's like runny egg yolk.
Definitely a lot more of like a mayonnaise flavor in this.
Yeah. Mm.
Nah, I prefer to chew on my eggs. You know what? And I feel it.
I you know what? I'll give you that one. That like there is something about knowing there's like an egg slice in there that's way more comforting. I don't know. I'm gonna try and dissect this. This isn't working.
Sandwiches were just not meant to be shared. Let's be honest.
I'm just gonna rip it off. Sorry.
Here you go, Jay.
Oh, shit.
Try some real fucking tuna tasting sandwich action.
Okay.
Give me some of that sandwich.
Honestly, like when it comes to the tuna, it all tastes the same.
What I want to mention though, is that all the breading for all the sandwiches in Japan, it's so fluffy. Light and fluffy. That's why it's some of my favorite breads, I think.
Oh my God, I just realized we're breaking bread, guys. Like true comrades.
Which one are we eating first?
I'm the family law.
Okay.
What's the difference?
There is no difference.
No. I can spot which one. That one's Lawson.
Okay.
No, that's Lawson.
I can tell the difference. No.
I'm a cool sus on this one.
No, the bread's different.
the bread hit different.
No, listen, try it. You'll know what I mean. Shit, I spat on the table. You'll know what I mean.
Honestly, Garnt, like you're the mediator in this one. Have both of those and tell me if there's a fucking difference.
They taste different.
Like the Family Mart one, it's great.
No, it's got a weird tinge to it.
Let's try the Lawson one.
Okay, so this one's the Lawson one, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let me try both.
It tastes the fucking same. Hold on.
Yeah, see what I mean?
Mm, Lawson one's better.
Yeah, okay, right? I agree. The Lawson one actually tastes like tuna.
It's so clean. Mm. I don't know what it is, man. The Lawson tuna sandwich, it's amazing.
It's like the initial taste, I bit into both and the initial taste was just like, okay, they both taste the same. And then the aftertaste from the Lawson's tuna, you actually get a taste of tuna.
It tastes like fish.
Yeah, it tastes like fish.
So if you like the taste of fish, I'd say the Lawson one is better. If you don't like the taste of fish, I'd say the Family Mart one is better.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll give that.
All right, let's try the-
Now let's try this abomination. Because honestly, there's a part of me that's thinking this is going to be good. Although mine's contaminated today.
This is my only strawberry. is this right?
I've only got one strawberry as well.
I got two in mine.
Honestly.
One thing that the sandwiches are guilty of doing here is that they look loaded in the front. They look like they're filled. And then you take one bite and you realize there's nothing in
the
back.
They clickbait you.
Yeah.
it's literally like the Walker's crisps.
Yeah.
Where you bite into it and most of it's just air.
And I found that Family Mart does that the worst. Family
you
Mart
think so?
Family Mart has this sandwich, right? That I used to get from Family Mart, which is egg and ham, I think. Mm. And in the front, man, it looks like it's bursting. It can't wait to get out. And you take one bite and then you realize like it goes from like this. Like it's so thin. All right, let's give this a shot.
All right.
That's not a sandwich.
Honestly?
It's just a cake.
It's a dessert.
It's a strawberry shortcake.
That's really fucking weird. Because you know what? It tastes like a strawberry shortcake, but then you're just chewing bread.
Proof that bread works with fucking anything.
No, that tastes wrong.
I'm not a fan of that.
I would rather just eat a strawberry shortcake.
That's like the equivalent of putting a burger, or like putting a patty between two bread.
Yeah.
Two breads slices and calling it a burger.
Yeah. Yeah, I've always seen those being sold because I think they sell all of those at like Lawson and 7-Eleven.
Yeah, they all have dessert sandwiches, which is just fucking weird.
I saw one with like, I saw one where it was like cream and lime.
Give it back, yeah.
Cream and lime.
Not lime, sorry, kiwi. It was kiwi slices with like
kiwi and lime,
cream.
I've seen that
one. Yeah. And I was like, that looks fucking whack.
One thing I will say, the whipped cream they use here in Japan, it's S tier whipped cream.
I agree.
Whipped cream to me doesn't really fucking taste like anything. I just kind of like-
You taste Japanese whipped cream and you think it tastes like-
I can stand that better. I don't like whipped cream.
You're telling me that the whipped cream did not carry what you just ate right there?
Honestly, the bread kind of carried it.
No, get out of here.
Yes, man, I swear.
I had like one quarter of a fucking strawberry. There's nothing happening.
I used to fucking despise like all cakes and stuff like that. Like strawberry shortcake, I was like, nah, that's some boring shit. But then I had strawberry shortcake here and I was like, oh my God.
Strawberry, I was exactly the same. Strawberry shortcake here blew my mind because the cake part is so fluffy and
the cream, man.
The whipped cream, Japanese whipped cream is the best I've tasted in the world. I will stand by that. That. And that's why Japanese sweets taste so good. A lot of it is just
my TED talk.
The whipped cream. What are we trying next, lads?
Should we try like the more like savory snacks, maybe like the fish and the meat snacks? Sure. Do you guys have any of those?
Sure. So gentlemen, as you know, one of the most well-known food items from Japan.
It's like, I
was trying to figure out what I was trying to say, but one of the most well-known food items from Japan is of course the jelly donuts, AKA.
You took me back there. I went, what?
The onigiri, which if you've basically watched any anime, you've seen characters eating onigiri.
The rice balls.
This is basically the closest we get to an actual Japanese sandwich because it's a rice sandwich.
Wait,
basically,
what is that?
Right? This is a.
Wait.
Oh, okay. Oh, my God. I did not. Where's the seaweed? Where is the seaweed?
That's like the best part. It's like the hot dog wrapper, right? Because the best part of a hot dog is the crunch.
Yeah.
Right? What is that?
It is a grilled salmon onigiri.
Oh, I have a grilled salmon one as well.
Okay, we all have
also have a grilled salmon one.
Salmon onigiri.
So yeah, as you know, me and Gon actually ate onigiri, and this is actually one of them that I was eating, and it was quite delicious as much as I was complaining. Show business.
Honestly, that is my favorite onigiri to get.
So
from Lawson's.
Really? I've never seen that one.
What do you mean from Lawson's? You mean from all of the places, Gon? Now, Lawson's, like every good big brain company, has their own product line, specifically the onigiri. They have the basic bitch onigiri.
Yeah.
It's like 100 yen. Now this shit is like 190 yen.
That's the premium shit.
You can't even see it. That's how premium it is.
Honestly, I will stand 7-Eleven hot foods and fried foods. I don't stand this onigiri.
What is that?
This is the most depressing looking onigiri I've ever seen.
But look at
I'm
that,
sorry.
Joey. It's like someone put the condom on wrong. What's
They put the condom on sideways instead of on top.
Now, let me show you what a good onigiri. Okay, actually, that could
it be looks the same. it's just a bigger condom.
No, that's how it should look. Look at that.
That's just a bigger condom.
That's beautiful.
Honestly, it's beautiful because every bite you get a bit of seaweed.
Here's the thing that differentiates between a good onigiri and a bad onigiri. It's the rice to insides ratio.
100%
right? Yes.
If there's like, if the first bite you bite into in an onigiri and you immediately hit the inside, that's a good onigiri.
Yeah, to be fair, a lot of the cheap ones, or even sometimes like if they've just filled it not quite right that one time, you do just get like four bites in. You're like, where is the fucking filling?
Where's the filling?
Yeah. I got to ask, do you boys actually eat onigiri anymore?
Yes.
Yeah, I still do.
You do? Mm-hmm. I gave up.
I do whenever I need a quick, whenever I literally need a quick snack.
Yeah, I'm just never in the mood for a block of carbs. You know what I mean? That's the problem. And like, there's not enough filling. I'd rather just have
And yet you get the fucking microwavable gyudons.
That's if like, I want to pig out. Like, I haven't had a gyudon in a long time. Right. Cause like that shit is dreadful. Like,
honestly, because sometimes I miss my lunch and I have like a filming or something and I just need to fill up my stomach as quickly as possible. And that's when I get so it's just like one onigiri that lasts me until dinner and it does everything it needs to do.
What is your favorite filling of the onigiri? So there's different flavors that you can have in it.
God, that's
normally all fish. There is sometimes grilled chicken, but honestly,
I'm not a fan of the chicken.
Don't get it. Like, because the good part about the fish one is that normally like seeps into the rest of the area. Yeah. But the chicken one just is a ball.
I'd have to say the tuna.
Tuna is my favorite as well.
Yeah. Actually, you are holding my favorite one, which is the salmon belly. It's really good premium salmon. In terms of the chicken, how do you guys feel about the onigiri where it doesn't really have a filling? It's just kind of like the grilled rice with grilled chicken or whatever.
I used to eat those when I was little, but as I got older, I was like, nah, I want something more like,
you know. It feels like satisfying. A fake meal. I don't know why. Right. I don't know why. When I first visited Japan, all I ate was like onigiri.
I think
I was
everyone's like
that. Because you're like, oh my God, I'm in Japan. I gotta eat the Japanese things. I can't get this at home. I can get a sandwich at home.
Yeah.
But then when I started living here, I'm like, yo, the sandwiches are pretty fucking bomb. have you tried these sandwiches? And they're like nearly the same price. What am I doing, man? And sandwiches are easier to eat because sometimes onigiri falls apart if you're in a rush.
Like onigiri to me, I never eat onigiri as a meal. Like if I'm having a lunch, I never pick onigiri as the lunch. No. Onigiri is a convenience if I need to stuff myself and have it not taste awful.
I just realized there's like no way for us to like share.
We're just gonna bite into it.
It's all salmon onigiri.
To be fair, I've never tried the Family Mart branded onigiri.
I have never
before.
Tried the seven onigiri as
I've had this one before and it's good, and I'm just gonna do a bite just to prove that it's good again.
Oh, look at that. Immediately.
How deep would I have to bite, do you reckon, to get the filling, Jay?
I just bit a whole ton of rice and it didn't even have any seaweed. I hit like one millimeter of fish there.
Let me give it a bite. I mean, how deep? This deep?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I already broke into salmon.
Yeah.
Look at that.
My salmon actually has like a little bit of like soy sauce in it. So the soy sauce kind of seeped into the rice a little bit. Mm. That's really
good.
Flavorful.
That's good. That's nice fatty salmon.
Mm. This is awful. I do not. Honestly, this is the most depressing looking grilled salmon I've ever seen.
7-Eleven, fix your shit.
Okay, so we can say Family Mart and Lawson have got their branded onigiri down pat.
Yeah, mm-hmm. If you want the best onigiri from a chain, I would highly recommend.
I would highly recommend Lawson's as well. Lawson's, especially the grilled salmon belly, that is fucking bomb.
What other cold or savory snacks do you guys tend to go for?
Okay, we have the-
You don't eat that.
I do not eat this. You know what this is? This is the seafood sticks that you see in every Asian restaurant. And I don't know why every Asian restaurant serves these.
Well, I don't want to make this a dick measuring contest, but mine's big. Although to be fair, I don't eat these, but every now and then Aki asked me to come and buy like one of these crab sticks.
Why?
Okay, I tried it. It's actually kind of good. If you like crab especially.
This isn't just like crab or fish. This is fish paste, cheese, and cod roe. That sounds dreadful.
Oh, my one's got like mayonnaise like inside of it.
Why?
It's a seafood steak, spicy roe.
That looks fucking awful.
Oh my God.
That looks disgusting.
Look at that. Look at that. Oh my God.
Try this.
This is just like,
smell it.
That smells awful. That smells like off tuna.
Yeah. Oh, it just dribbled.
Smell that.
Ooh.
That does smell like bad tuna, doesn't it?
Ooh.
I really don't want to eat it.
That is like the fishiest fish smell ever.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm not even going to open this. I'm just going to eat yours.
Yeah. You know when you just have fish that's been left out for a few days?
I'll just take that.
That's what this smells like. It smells like-
The thing is, I usually fuck with the crab sticks at like summer festivals and stuff like that. So I hope this is something like that.
It's not good. It's bad.
Not good.
Oh God. No, that is bad.
That's awful, that is. I just prefer the normal crab stick. Don't put shit in it, don't put cheese in it. I can't even taste the cheese.
I don't like
crab. I definitely taste the cheese.
Okay, I don't like crab sticks. Because crab is one food that I think just doesn't taste good processed. And crab sticks just feel like, they feel like such processed food.
It's like canned lobster. You want canned lobster. No one wants
But you gotta, lobster. You gotta have, with the crab sticks though, I used to think the same, but like you go to like a summer festival and you get the ones that are like on the fucking grill with like the
fucking
sauce.
Oh yeah, but that's fucking
that
good.
That shit is fire.
Yeah, but it's not, I don't think it's the crab that tastes good. It's the fact that it's grilled and it's got the sauce on it. I'd rather have another.
It can be good.
I think it's really good, yeah.
This video is sponsored by Bokksu. Connor, what is Bokksu?
Bokksu is the only Japanese snack box that partners with over 100-year-old family snack makers to deliver Japan's exclusive snacks right to your door. And I have to say, I've never seen any of these at a konbini, so that probably means they're premium.
Look at this. I love my soft cookies and this, I'm going to have this.
Well, boys, March is the start of the hanami season.
Oh, what's hanami, Joe?
Or the cherry blossom season in Japan, as it's called. So to commemorate that, Bokksu orders placed in March will get a special hanami-themed pink box instead of Bokksu's signature orange. But be quick, because these stocks are limited. It's right here.
First time Bokksu customers will receive the Seasons of Japan box so they could get a taste of the snacks per season.
Repeated customers will get a themed box every month. Gentlemen, what kind of snacks do you like?
I'm a giant senbei fan, and this is a rather extraordinary looking senbei.
That's the black sesame taiko with the kumamon design.
I love me some sesame, so I'm very down.
What do you got there, Garnt?
I have here a cookie. Joey, what is this cookie?
Oh, that's the Aomori apple caramel yakoi sable.
Damn, that Aomori sounds sexy.
All I know for the apples, right? All I know is I like me my soft cookies, and this
looks so good.
This is a nice, soft, moist
cookie.
God,
I want a cup of tea.
Best part is, it's vegetarian.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Joey, what's yours?
Well, my favorite one is the stick potato super mucho plum. We talked about the sour plums on this episode.
Yeah.
So you know me, I love me my sour plum. So if there's a sour plum snack, you know I'm going
to
dig that.
Ooh, that looks nice. And gentlemen, I'm sure we can all agree that ever since moving to Japan, Japan's snack game is just on another level.
Oh yeah, there's no competing with
it. No one can travel at the moment, but if you want a taste of Japan and all their glorious snacks, you can do that by getting yourself a Bokksu.
Bokksu honors Japanese heritage and artisanal makers by partnering with them to bring authentic flavors around the world.
So get 10% off, save up to $47 on your own authentic Japanese snack box from Bokksu using our link.
Be sure to use code TRASHTASTE 10 for 10% off.
Back to the video.
What you got there, Connor?
What do you got there, Connor?
This is rather odd looking.
It's like a fucking whole deli.
So it's just a bunch of cuts of bacon, it looks like, but like
sausages.
We're about to show off why Japanese bacon is just one of the worst bacons you can find in the world.
I'll try my best to hold this up without burning myself.
Okay, so this is Japanese bacon here.
This is a meat platter,
and
you will.
As you can see, it is floppy and soggy.
That's gonna go, oh God.
Don't flop it around.
I just wanna show off that this is not what bacon should look like or feel
this
like.
This is two kinds of sausage and pepper bacon.
I mean, so, what are we trying?
I'll try the one kind of sausage.
I'll try the other kind then. Whatever one is.
Should we cut one in half actually?
Yeah.
But what else do you have there in the meantime, Jay, while I prepare
Okay,
this?
Well, I know you guys have never tried this, but we have nanko ume, kishu nanko ume, which is pickled plums.
Pickled plums. You think I haven't tried that? I actually have tried that.
Okay, but there's two different types.
Because for some reason, Sydney fucking loves pickled plums, and I do not know why.
Here's the thing. Literally, I don't know if this is just a stereotype. Literally, every female I know loves pickled plums. I don't know why. If it's like an actual plum flavored thing.
Maylin, yeah. Is it true?
Like,
Maylin, do you like pickled plum?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Chicks love pickled plums. I don't understand. Literally every Japanese girl I know loves pickled plum flavored shit.
All right, boys, tell me what kinds of sausage you would like to have. Go on, give me one of them.
What are the different?
I'll give you one that looks like a finger.
Yeah.
It's basically
straight up a finger. Like, it looks like a finger.
That's like fucking out of Yoshi. That's out of Kira's collection, man.
Yeah, exactly.
There's Yoshikage Kira's.
There's one thing that Japan just doesn't do, and it's sausages. Like, they just don't do them right. No. And like, they'll go around calling this chorizo. Like, that's what they're in restaurants.
That is not chorizo.
They will call this chorizo. It's a joke. I mean, it's literally a hot dog.
It's just a sausage, eh?
It's just a sad
Frankfurt. Yeah. That's what it is.
You can palate cleanse, though, with Akisu and Uncle.
Okay, they don't need to see this.
Let me try the bacon. Yeah, shit.
Yeah, I'll give you guys the pickle plums because we have three.
Okay, so this is actually something new. I'm sure the viewers watching, they've tasted bacon before. They've tasted sausages. They've tasted hot dogs.
Yeah.
What they haven't tasted is pickled plums.
Yeah. So Japan is like kind of known for its pickled plum. Umeboshi, it's called.
Yeah, umeboshi.
But basically there's two types of umeboshi. There's the really, really sour types of umeboshi
that's the only one I've had.
This is the sweet umeboshi.
There's sweet umeboshi?
Yes, this is amakuchi umeboshi.
Well, this one too?
Yes, this is, yeah,
so
these
this
are all
is the
same.
Sour ones.
No, these are the sweet ones. These are all sweet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'll try it.
So
slightly salted, sweet umeboshi.
Oh shit, it's dripping everywhere.
Yeah, watch out.
Okay, let me taste this.
I know you guys haven't tried this.
Why does it look like a deflated scrotum?
because it's been dried, basically. What do you think?
I'm not a fan. I'm still not a fan.
So would you just take a big bite?
Yeah, there's a seed inside of it.
Yeah, watch out for the seed.
Oh, it's so sour.
Really? This is the sweet one.
This is the sweet one. Okay.
This is sweet?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
In what universe is this sweet?
Yeah, this is the sweet one.
So if you have the sour one, it's literally like, what's the most sour thing you can normally get in like
sour Western countries?
It's way more sour than
You know that one video we did with Joey's channel where we had to eat the powdered sour? Just like a bite of that.
That's basically pickled plum.
Yeah, it's like I bought this thing for my channel, which is pure umeboshi extract, and it's considered one of the most sour things in the world.
That's fucking awful.
Yeah, it's basically you start salivating immediately. It's one of the most sour things you can just naturally get.
Mm, it was really good. My grandma used to hand make these. So okay. That's why I have like a special
I do think there is a lot of at play of like, I am not used to these foods. And although I'm more than happy to try every single item, doesn't mean I have to like every single item.
Yeah, no, of course not. What I don't understand about pickled plums is that why do you like eating something that sour? Like, it's so sour. It's more sour than any kind of sweet or any kind of-
I don't know, like I used to, because again, like my grandma used to like hand make the umeboshi and would just send it in Tupperware, right? Yeah. And it's like, it is the most sour shit imaginable.
If I had a Japanese grandma that made it for me, I'm sure I'd love the fuck out of it, right?
I would just come home after school and just get the Tupperware and just fucking eat it.
That's got love in it, Jerry. Yeah. Yeah. That didn't have love. That had factories and suffering. That tastes like shit.
My grandma's umeboshi is the best.
Did your mouth just look like this?
Yeah, end? All the time, but I fucking loved it.
Because that's me after one bite of eating umeboshi.
Yeah, I don't know, I love it.
Yeah,
another items that you can get that are, you know, you won't really find elsewhere in the world probably is a lot of dried fish items that are like snackable.
Oh, right? Yeah.
So Garnt has some.
I have some squid and seaweed tempura chips.
So tempura is a kind of light batter.
It's a light batter frying.
I have salmon skin chips, which they really didn't go with the good name.
I kind of fuck with these.
No, I like these.
Yeah.
I also really fucking love all of the squid stuff. Like fried squid. What's the other one? Like
the dried squid?
Dried squid as well. I like. They have like a certain type of frying technique for some of the squids that are really good.
Yeah.
It looks fucking vile when you pull this out of the package, like octopus. It looks so gross, but it's pretty good. So should we bust some of these open? Just give them a shot.
Let's try them out.
Joey, you want to have a? Oh, actually, you know what? Wow, they look like crisps.
Yeah. So these are designed to basically look like fish crisps, right?
That's crazy. That's kind of epic.
Like, that's kind of epic.
That's an epic gamer moment.
Yeah, look at that.
So hold on, right? So look at that. That could be like a square. Do you have squares in Australia? They're a British crisp.
No, I don't think so.
They look exactly like this, don't they?
Yeah.
Wow.
But they also, they smell like you think they smell. It's a very it's a very fishy smell that they smell like, obviously, because it's fish.
That's good, I like that. With a beer?
With a beer, with a beer, cheers, boys.
Cheers, gentlemen.
That's great. I love that. I feel like I just worked a hard day fishing in the middle of nowhere in Aomori. You know what I mean? Like, takes me back.
Honestly, these taste so good with beers. I just kind of want to eat.
Give me one.
Give me one.
Okay, let's try one of these. Try one of these.
I don't think I've tried these.
These have a bit more bite to them.
Ooh. That's good.
They got some texture to them, don't they?
That's like the unhealthier version of this, I swear.
Yeah, because this is basically that with a bit more batter. So you got a bit more of a bite.
I think I might prefer these ones.
Those are nice. Those have a really nice crunch. These have a nice crunch.
I'm having another one, man.
Let me bring out another snack that I'm sure you guys have probably never seen or heard of before.
Okay.
And I'm glad that Ashley brought them. It's carinto.
What is that?
Ah, I did buy these one time. Yeah. I thought they were chocolate.
Yeah.
They weren't chocolate.
Most people look at this and go, oh look, it's actual pieces of turd that they're
packaged. I thought it was chocolate. I was so hyped to dig in.
What is it?
Basically, it is black sugar particles, but when you pull
black sugar particles,
black sugar like
really selling me on this.
It's like fried black sugar, right? I'm pretty sure
that sounds like a physics term.
But when you pull it out, it straight up just looks like a turd.
Okay,
like I don't know what to tell
you. That's a very fancy name for a turd.
That
looks
like, yeah, that is a turd.
That's like Brian Griffin's poop.
Yeah, there you go.
That's what is this?
You know what that looks? You know what this looks like? This looks like a turd that like a Pomeranian would do. Cheers, yeah, like a small
cheers,
dog.
Cheers.
Cheers.
You know what? That ain't bad.
Yeah, right?
It just tastes like
sugar with air.
It just tastes like a crisp sugar.
Yeah. It's basically just deep fried sugar. Yeah.
I honestly don't really like that. I'm not gonna
really?
Lie. That doesn't really taste
like it. Black sugar's kind of a hit or a miss with a lot of people.
That's a miss.
So the thing is, I couldn't eat a whole packet of these.
Yeah.
I chomp on one of these. I'm like, that was nice. Am I getting a craving to go for one more? Nope. One's enough for me.
So wait, what is this in Japanese again?
This is called kokuto karinto.
What a fucking name.
So kokuto is black sugar. Karinto is like the name of the actual snack.
How unhealthy is it to just eat the entire thing?
What's the calories on that one?
Calories? 698.
For how many grams?
For the whole bag, 135
fucking
grams.
Fucking hell, how much sugar is in that bitch?
I mean, you're just eating pure sugar.
Yeah.
No, 37 grams.
Wait, that's way less than I expected.
No. I mean, it just feels like you're eating fried sugar.
There's actually more carbs in this. There's 81 grams of carbs.
Holy fuck. No.
Okay.
Oh
my
God.
There's 7 grams of protein in this thing.
Oh, well, great. After a workout.
Yeah, perfect. After a workout.
Where's the protein coming from?
I have no idea.
Where the fuck is the protein coming from?
I have no idea.
They're literally making protein out of thin air here.
Japan be doing that.
Did they just put like a little bit of protein powder in it? Just like balance it out.
We're gonna make this healthy somehow.
Exactly. Shall we get out
a giant
else?
Bag full of things now? These are more like, I guess, sweets or kind of.
All right. Shall we just dump the rest on the table and see what we got? All right. Look at all that. Let's.
Holy fuck! I have a lot
see,
more than
let's
you
see
guys.
What Santa.
I have us. Way more than I think you guys
what
do.
What is that?
Why do you have
you
so
bought?
Many? What the fuck?
I do
you have
know.
So many sweets there.
All right, shall I just start with the stuff that looks interesting? Okay, first of all, one of my favorite Japanese snacks. It's got to be top. It's top tier for me, this S tier.
Okay. Mochi senbei?
Senbei in general, though.
Oh, yeah, senbei in general.
Not mochi, but senbei in general. There's a senbei store not too far from us.
Yeah.
I go there like every week to get my weekly
yeah,
supply.
Yeah, I do
of
as
senbei.
Well. It's so
Dude,
good.
Oh, fuck. Senbei is so good. If you don't know, it's like a rice cracker, but it's basically like, it doesn't feel too heavy and you can have like one or two and you feel like really satisfied. It's not too bad for you either.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just
it,
like
it feels
rice.
Like, it feels like a crisp, but just lighter. And for some reason, it's more filling than a single crisp.
Oh yeah, an entire packet of senbei is like
so
a
this
meal.
Is much, yeah, oh my God, whoa, this does have a funky texture to it.
Okay.
Is it soft?
Yeah, it's like a soft cookie, a soft baked senbei.
Ooh, okay, is it chewy? It looks chewy.
Oh my God.
What is that? Okay.
Oh, this is, yeah, so mochi senbei is kind of in the same, so there's what different the- types. There's hard senbei and then there's soft senbei.
So there's hard senbei and then there's rock fucking solid senbei. There are some senbei where I've had, there was one it was like yuzu pepper or something. And I was like, oh, that sounds amazing. So I order it, right? And I fucking like break my teeth, I swear, biting on this shit.
What is it, like a jawbreaker kind of senbei?
Honestly, there's like, there's the perfect hardness, which it just cracks immediately upon.
It's like a rice cracker.
Right, that's what you want.
And then some of them, it just feels like you're biting into a stone.
Wow, that's really weird.
If this was a cookie, I would think this is the perfect kind of texture
this is what
I'm looking for in a cookie.
There's actually one more level above this called nure senbei, which literally means wet senbei. And it's like actually like wet. But they make it for old people who can't like break into hard senbei.
Now that's wholesome.
Okay.
Right, let's give it a shot.
Okay.
What the fuck? Whoa, that's weird.
Yeah, so mochi rice is actually different from regular rice. Mochi rice is a lot softer and a lot more like squishier. So you get something like this. Yeah, it's a little whack, ain't it?
Oh, that's so bizarre.
Yeah.
I don't like it. Okay, so to
you know what it is? It's moist.
To explain
why is Maylene laughing? What's funny, Maylene?
I love Garnts.
Oh.
To explain what I just experienced. So as we said, this has the perfect texture for like a good cookie. And like my experience has taught me that I'm gonna bite into this and it's gonna taste sweet. And what I tasted was a salted cracker with a moist cookie texture.
It isn't bad though. I'd eat it. Like I wouldn't search for it, but I'd eat it.
That texture and taste just doesn't belong together. I don't know, something about that.
What else
you've,
do you
you've kind
have?
Of been conditioned, right?
Maybe so, because I taste it and it tastes good. And I feel the texture and the texture feels good, but together it just does not synergize at all. It's like anti-umami, man.
It's like a plus and a minus put together, right?
But it looks like you have a senbei there, guy.
Yeah, I have a
a big boy senbei.
I have a proper senbei.
Oh, that's a kabukiage.
Yeah. This is
my favorite type of senbei. Kabukiage.
Fucking hell, God.
Yeah, Jesus.
I just want to show how hard it is.
We actually have the smaller kabukiage. These ones I buy quite
these
regularly.
I like these, but when you have like four or five, you start to feel sick.
Oh, yeah.
They're so like, what's the word to describe them?
These are really good.
Yeah. So yeah, there it's like, how would you describe the texture? It's
cavernous.
It's like the thing from Fantastic Four, isn't it?
I don't know what it is that's like amazing for like one or two bites, but really like sickly after like three. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
I don't know, man. I could destroy a whole packet.
Maybe
of
it's just me. It's gotta be just me.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not bad though. I mean,
these are my favorite types of senbeis, I think.
So what? This tastes exactly the same. as what we just had, but this is the texture I imagine that taste having. It's just like, it's a nice salty cracker just with a bit more air in between, or like it's fatter mm-hmm. than the cracker, but it's lighter than the cracker. Yeah. It's kind of like eating like cardon foam, but just like flavored.
Right, Joe, right. What are we having from yours?
Okay, so I've never actually seen this before, but I know this brand, Baby Star Ramen. So Baby Star Ramen is like, yeah, it is. So basically Baby Star Ramen is like the kind of really, what's the word? It's like the dried out ramen.
Oh, is it the instant ramen?
It's like the instant ramen looking things, but it's in a snack form. And I guess this is like the maze soba flavored one, right, which I've never seen before.
So you just eat it dry?
Oh, look at that. It's like, what? It's like little snacks. It's literally tiny instant ramen.
Oh my God. That looks next level. I need to try this. Here you go.
You know, I hate this is my first concern, but this just cannot be even remotely healthy, right?
Of course it's not healthy. It's literally fried instant ramen noodles.
It's fine.
I kind of like it.
Okay. I don't know if you did the same thing, but as a child, sometimes you would, sometimes I would take instant ramen, like hardened instant ramen, and just kind of like smash it up into little pieces, put like the seasoning on it and just eat it like it was like a snack.
Yeah, we had a brand of that. It's called Mammy Noodles. Like they would actually sell packets of that shit. This, it was the best.
What are you in prison? What are you doing for?
Because it tastes fucking great.
Fuck off.
Ash, you know Mammy Noodles, right?
I did the same thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Have you never had like the ramen seasoning or like the instant noodle seasoning?
No.
It tastes fucking bomb. It's like putting the seasoning.
It's like MSG. Yeah. It's like pure MSG.
All right, now I'm salt.
Yeah.
Like it's, as a kid, I was told to never do that because it's unhealthy as fuck, but it's this.
But I guess someone grew up and was like, I can make a product out of that.
This literally tastes like childhood.
Yeah.
It tastes like every Asian childhood.
It's got a little spice to it too, which is nice.
Okay. It's so good on salad.
Salad?
You mean croutons? They're not croutons.
Yeah, they're not croutons. They do look like croutons.
They do kind of look like croutons.
It's like a Japanese crouton.
What is this? Watashi no, what is that?
Karashi.
Karashi, what is that?
Yeah, that's mustard.
What is this?
I don't actually crack know it what open. It is. Yeah, let's crack it
this
open.
This is from Lawson's. I don't know what it is. Our intern just bought it.
I have no idea what it is either.
What's that?
Right. That just looks like a potato chip, I guess.
The fuck? Oh my God, that has a kick to it.
Oh, there we go.
Wow.
Oh my God.
That has a kick.
Okay. I'm not a fan.
Yeah, you don't like condiments. This is like condiments in a stick.
It tastes like mayo and mustard in like a crisp. Mm. That's so weird.
It's horrible. I actually kind of fuck with it.
It's fucking horrible. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? You're like condiments are meant to be, you know, are meant to enhance food. Mm. They're not meant to be the food. I literally just ate hardened mustard and mayo.
I actually kind of like that. Yeah, it's actually kind of good, eh? Oh. It has a really strong like mustard kick to it. But
so I'll pick another one because I have too many.
Yeah.
What looks interesting? That's, we literally just have these in the UK.
Yeah, so. Yeah, that's fine.
What are those?
What's this? Like the biscuits? You have these
The cream.
The custard creams, biscuits? That's what they look like. This is cognac, chips, seaweed, and salt.
Cognac?
Yeah, cognac, yeah. Mm. Low in calories, natural Lawson's. Okay.
Okay.
Should we give it a shot?
Konnyaku does have zero calories, so.
Well, gamers, let's give it a shot. Gaunt, go ahead.
Thank you very much.
Go ahead, gamers.
Look at that.
That looks healthy. I don't know if that's a good comment. Yeah, I don't know.
That looks very healthy. I can literally see through it. That's how you know how healthy it is.
Okay, not just anything. That is the most inoffensive thing ever.
Yeah.
That tastes like air with a hint of seaweed.
Try these.
The moment like moisture hits it, it just dissolves and disappears.
That was literally like eating nothing.
Rice Krispie if it had been scaled up in size, but not with like the added ingredients needed to scale it up.
It's literally just going to Photoshop and doing
Have you seen that video on the internet where someone manages to like deep fry water? Someone managed to deep fry water, right? Like a packet of water. That's what I imagine that tastes like.
Why would they do that?
All right, I've got here castella.
I don't know what castella is.
Oh, that's the castellas. Oh, that's like a specific type of Japanese castella.
Because normally it's in like a block.
It's like a block, yeah.
Which country is castella from?
Look it up.
What is castella? Do you want to explain?
We'll find out.
Yeah, castella's
buy one castella.
Okay.
Castella's like a cake of kinds, right? Or it's like a pastry? Yeah.
Okay, it looks like a pastry. It's
really fucking good.
Oh, look.
Is it really?
Okay, so it's made in Japan. Looks like a little pastry.
Dude, it's good. Try
it. It's like a cream puff.
Okay, let me.
Okay, that's good. Mm. That is fucking good.
Spanish.
I thought so. Okay.
Spanish.
Portugal.
One thing
is
I'm
that nice or not? That's a nice clean cake.
One thing I've noticed about the pastry here that I love, everything is fluffy as fuck.
Yeah, so
I
fluffy.
Love.
Yo, give me another one of those. Those are fucking clean. You just want a castella?
Like from the shortcake to the bread, to the to the whipped cream, to the fucking castella.
Yeah.
Everything is so fluffy.
Mm. Soft and fluffy.
Soft and fluffy.
I saw a bit just fucking.
Which is why it's so easy to eat sweets here, because they find a different way to market different kind of sweets, and they all taste fucking amazing. Yeah. You really can't go wrong with sweets.
Well, I'm gonna try something from the Family Mart collection.
Okay. Whoa, is that an Italian import?
It's using proper Italian caramel sauce, popcorn.
Isn't caramel just sugar?
It's literally just fried sugar.
But like, I won't lie. One thing that I've been, as I've said in the podcast before with the movie theaters, I've been very impressed with popcorn in Japan. Mm. They have really taken popcorn.
I'm not a huge fan of popcorn, but let me try.
Honestly, Japanese popcorn, if you come here, it's fucking good. Yeah, you think popcorn is like an American staple? Mm. Like, it's good shit.
Actually, that's not too sweet.
Mm.
That is just popcorn. I don't know. I don't really care about popcorn.
Go to a movie theater in Japan. Make sure you get popcorn. Get the half and half. You won't be disappointed.
Okay, so the thing about popcorn is me, is that I'm never the one to buy popcorn, but I'll always take it if someone's got
I'm
it.
Always that
like
guy.
I never go out of my way to be like, okay, I am craving popcorn now. I need popcorn. Mm. I'm always the guy who's just like, okay, there's popcorn. I mean, I'm gonna take some if it's there, but yeah. I'm never gonna go
like,
out of my
I'll
way.
Never order my own popcorn at a theater, but if someone has popcorn, I'm taking it.
Yeah, exactly. Right? If I'm offered, I'm not gonna say no.
I just read what this is called.
What?
This is the most unappetizing name I've ever heard in my life.
Go on.
Okay.
Sugar Rusk is the English name.
Rusk?
And sugar it's actually rusk. In Japanese as Sugar Rusk.
Sugar
Rusk.
Are you sure they didn't like just try to spell out Sugar Rush? I'm just kind of fucked
I'm having
up.
A Sugar
where's,
Rusk.
Where's the Fortnite Chug Jug? Wow, look at that.
What is
take
it?
One, let me take one. What is, okay. I look at this.
Mini baguette business.
Yeah.
I look at this and I'm like, this should not taste sweet. If I bite into this and it tastes sweet.
This is like those like party baguettes where you put like a little bit of like salmon on top
yeah,
of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, you put a little salmon, put a little bit of mozzarella cheese. Let's have
la,
it.
La.
Like, right. like at a fancy house party.
Why?
Oh, but it's really sweet.
Why? It's you literally know, sugar on a baguette.
It's sugar on a baguette.
Nope.
That's
nope.
fucked up.
That, I'm noping the fuck out of there.
Get the fuck out of here.
That is like going against like everything the France the fought, fuck? Like France fought for.
They did not have the French Revolution, so this could happen.
Yeah, exactly.
That's, although, oh God, that's-
To help us out.
Oh God.
Lawson's has a collaboration with, how do you pronounce this?
Godiva?
Is it Godiva or Godiva? I think it's Godiva, Godiva. Right?
No one knows.
It's Godiva.
So they have like their own collection of like chocolate. Yeah. Like, and honestly, I'm not gonna lie, it looks fucking
sexy.
Honestly,
anytime they have, so Family Mart or Lawson's.
Wait, give me that.
What is it called?
That's fucking curry
oh,
bread.
Oh, what?
It's karepan.
Is that curry bread?
It's curry bread.
Oh no, oh
this is,
no.
This is chocolate bread.
This is beef curry bread in a chocolate bun.
Yo, crack that open. Let's give it a shot. Let's
hold
give
on,
it a
I
shot.
I gotta try this.
Okay. This is gonna be a trash taste first here.
What?
Because I have literally never-
Oh my God, your shirt's
oh my
Yo, pull
God,
it out, pull it
what
out.
What is that? What is that?
What? That's, that looks like a donut.
It's like, it looks like curry bread, but with, it's if it's like made out of chocolate.
Yo, okay, so open up a napkin and rip that shit open.
So to explain what curry bread is normally like, it's literally, you take Japanese curry, and then you deep fry it in a katsu, right? And katsu bread, and then it's kind of like a jelly filled donut, except imagine the filling was curry.
Yeah,
that's curry,
and it's fucking good.
And curry, normal curry bread is fucking amazing. This is not normal curry bread.
This is an abomination.
I'm actually excited because I want to know what the fuck is going on.
Yeah, okay, like how is the synergy of chocolate and curry?
Okay.
If I like this, what does that say about?
Okay, I will say for. Experience points. One of the worst combinations I've had was when I went to this Wisconsin State Fair in the USA, and they were selling chocolate bacon. They would literally take bacon and dip it in chocolate.
That ain't it.
I'm about to find out if there is a worse combination right now than chocolate bacon.
I don't know, man. Chocolate bacon sounds fucking horrible.
Okay. Well, chocolate curry bread, that also sounds horrible.
All right.
Oh, okay. Look at that. All okay, right. So from the looks of it, it literally looks like a curry in between chocolate bread.
That smells like just a contradiction. You know, let's give it a bite. Let's bite into it, boys. Oh, that's fucked up. That's fucked up. That ain't right.
No.
I don't like that. Do you like that, Joey?
I kind of like it.
No.
Wait.
No.
That's awful. That's awful. That's awful.
That is so awful. Oh my God. Oh my God.
I don't know if I'm just fucked up, but that just tastes like curry bread to me.
No, it tastes, what are you talking about?
I legitimately can't taste the chocolate.
I can't taste the chocolate. All I get is like a weird bitter aftertone.
It's even worse than chocolate bread because it's not even sweet. It's the, you can taste the cocoa in the chocolate and then you bite into it and then you get a mouthful of curry. It's an aftertaste that you
This is the-
I like legitimately can't taste the chocolate at all.
Do you taste the cocoa though, right?
I bet with this one, it's gonna be rich. This is the chocolate bread and it's their collaboration with Godiva.
Oh God, get that away from me. I literally feel-
To me, that just tastes like a curry bread. So I liked it.
Oh.
Now that looks good. Is a heart attack. That is a heart attack and a piece of bread.
Did you get a whiff of that?
Yeah, yeah.
That was heavy chocolate.
That's how chocolate should look like. Chocolate breads, yes, please.
Dude, I get like a nosebleed after eating one piece of Godiva chocolate, let alone this whole fucking bread.
The chocolate bread, which actually looks pretty fucking good.
Okay, looks good. But that's because they're not being adventurous with fucking curry bread.
Look, if there's one thing you shouldn't put in chocolate bread, it's curry.
There's a nice cross section. We've got some
chocolate paste that is here. Very strong.
Chocolate paste on chocolate bread.
It smells like heaven. Let's have a whiff. Oh, that's...
Chocolate is spelled C.
Fuck, that's really good.
Honestly, a little disappointed.
Really?
Okay, no.
You don't like that? I really like it.
The chocolate tastes very artificial.
The chocolate tastes good. I don't like the bread. That tastes not as good as it's chewy bread as well. It's not the fluffy bread. I like the chewy bread. Chewy bread doesn't taste good with the chocolate that they put in there.
I fuck with it.
Joey, you fuck with anything, Joey.
I do.
Joey's like, is that fucking weird? I fuck with that.
Yeah.
Is this seasoned vomit? I mean, yeah. I'm gonna try it. I'd fuck with that.
I'm the kind of guy who's like, I don't want to offend anyone. So if I went to another country and they're like, this is what we eat. And it's just vomit with seasoning. I'd be like, well, I mean, I don't want to offend anyone. So I'll give it a shot. I'll be like, it's great.
Yeah, you don't have to like it at all.
Yeah,
know?
Just but trying it.
Just trying it, I think, is like more of an appreciation to the culture than honestly anything else.
What was presented here was a massive disappointment from the usual kind of-
It Godiva. Looks like sex. Right? Yeah. This looks like sex. Like, it tastes like it should be like fucking amazing. And how many calories is this bad boy? So 254 calories, 31 grams of sugar, carbohydrates, and 29 grams of sugar.
So damn. The black sugar poop pieces were less healthier than that.
Yeah, I know. And I've got here some almond cookies.
Yo, okay, I fuck with that.
But
okay.
In Japanese, it's called almond balls.
Why do they look like that?
I don't know. Well, they don't look like
they look
cookies.
They look like bonbons.
Yeah, they look like fucking bonbons, don't they? Okay, let's...
I do fuck with anything that has almonds
in it. I'm just getting so
full. Almonds are easily my favorite type of nut.
Oh, that's kind of nice. Yeah, almond is a good nut.
Almond is like...
Top tier.
One
nut.
Of the top
S-tier.
Tier.
S-tier nut.
If we were gonna like tier the nuts, almonds up.
All right, let's give it a shot, boys. Whoa, that was weird.
It's covered in powdered sugar.
Okay, so I don't know why I thought it was gonna be soft on the inside. It wasn't. It's just shortbread.
You know what this tastes like? It tastes like something you'd buy in Hawaii. You know what I mean? It's like very
Why Hawaii? No,
it tastes like somewhere you go to like a food festival and they're like, here's our new weird thing. We mash up almonds, put them in a bowl and put sugar on them. It's like, I mean, yeah, sure.
I don't know. It tastes very like, kind of like tropical.
It's good.
No, it's good, but why?
Just eat an almond, you know what I mean?
It just tastes like shortbread with a bit of almond in
it. That's true, yeah. That's spot on, actually.
Yeah, it's shortbread with almond and some frosting on the side. I think that's literally just-
I mean, that's literally all. You just basically just described what it was.
I just described it as a whole.
Okay. That's okay. I mean, that's, you know.
It's okay.
I'm not going to go and buy that.
Okay.
But I'll eat it.
Now we are getting to the point where you might recognize some of these brands, mm-hmm. but so I've got here some Kit Kat.
Is that sweet potato?
What is this?
That's
flavor?
Sweet potato, right?
That's Benimo, which is like red potato, I think it's.
Oh. Red potato.
I think it's called taro in English. I don't know.
I have never
heard of it. You always.
It's just sweet potato. Yeah,
okay, so this is sweet potato so Kit when, Kat.
Whenever you see this paste or this color, it's always sweet potato, I've learned in Japan.
Yeah.
They love it. They put it on everything.
Yeah.
Honestly, sweet potato kind of slaps, but.
Whoa.
Okay.
Whoa.
It's
hello.
It's a ball of Kit Kat. Let's.
It's a Kit Kat ball.
We bite that in half. We got a cross section going on. Okay, it's like wafer. Yeah, it's good.
Yeah.
I would eat that. And
you can't go wrong with a Kit Kat, I find.
No.
I feel like this is just a Kit Kat.
It is.
I mean,
it's literally just, they took a Kit Kat and they went.
Honestly, I would say that tastes better than a Kit Kat.
I prefer that over a regular Kit Kat.
Yeah, I would say. You don't.
Is that one or one bag?
One bag.
I was going to say, I thought
it was 244 calories for one ball.
I was like, oh my God. I'm going to go to the toilet right now.
We all three of us would have had a heart attack.
Oh my God. I was getting scared there. I was like, why does it taste so good?
All right. I got, I've never seen these before. But
fancy
shit.
Smoky pretz.
Yeah, pretz. This is smoked potato butter flavor.
So pretz is just like-
Smoked potato butter.
Smoked potato butter.
Pretz are just like basically flavor.
Savory pokey.
Yeah, I'm losing words right now. Savory
pokey. I prefer pretz over pokey, personally.
They have.
They're savory. Yeah,
if you go to the supermarket, you'll see that flavor, and you always see the pizza flavor. Which they have.
Yeah.
So they have pizza flavored sticks, which I feel like, why? Just eat a fucking pizza.
Yeah, just eat a pizza.
Pizza shouldn't be a flavor because there's different flavors of pizza. So what is pizza flavor?
I quite like that.
I like that.
I hate that I like that.
Mm. You can never go wrong with pretz, honestly.
Yeah, pretz.
If you're looking for a savory snack, pretz is the way to go.
Oh, that aftertaste is gross. I'm getting a really bad aftertaste.
You can taste like
what's this? What's this flavor again?
Smoky potato butter. I can taste the smokiness of it.
I can taste the butter as well.
Mm. Oh Jesus, that's awful.
Okay.
Another one from Natural Lawson. So there are two types of Lawsons.
Yep.
I'm getting very full, gentlemen.
We're nearly done. There is the Natural Lawsons, which tends to have more healthy options, healthy snacks, healthy meals. It's actually pretty good. It's a pretty cool marketing strategy. And so they have their own brand of stuff. And this is the cranberry cookies with gaba.
Cranberry cookies?
Gaba.
Gaba, as it says.
Isn't gaba like the stuff they put in energy drinks?
Oh yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Cranberry cookie. Is what it says in Japanese.
Very good Japanese. Hungry Joseph.
Yeah, I was looking for gaba, and I was like, where's gaba?
It's literally at the top. It says gaba.
Gaba.
You gonna point at the camera?
They literally spell gaba in English.
Yeah.
It's like, gaba. Fuck it. It's called gaba.
They just gave up on their own language.
It's enriched chocolate.
Enriched chocolate? That's what gaba is?
Yeah, it has amino.
Amino butyric acid.
So this I know is exactly
to,
what
this
that
is supposed to be healthy. So what is it like?
Yeah, so the stuff in Natural Lawson is way more healthy. So it should be healthier.
So one of these is that one bag? 65 calories? Is that right?
7.5
grams? Oh, that might be. I'll just give it a shot anyway. You can tell me, Joey. I'll hand it to you.
Okay. There you go. Okay. That's this looks like a diet. This looks like a diet. This,
like a Belvita?
Yeah, this looks like a diet snack. It looks like a diet bar, honestly.
How many calories? Is it bag or like, what is it?
So it's per meal.
Meal?
Yeah, which is 17 and a half grams. Oh, this is 35 grams. So, okay, so two. So
it's 100.
So half a bag is 65 calories.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
Not for like what looks to be like a very heavy snack.
Yeah, let's have a taste.
That's literally like a Belvita.
It is a Belvita.
What's a Belvita?
It's like the diet like cookies or diet biscuits with like it's all you have them in every country.
Yeah. This tastes like something like my grandma would have had. It's like grandma, can I have some snacks? And she's like, here you go.
I quite like that.
I like that.
That's
good.
Nice. I actually, if I had a Natural Lawson's closer to me, I'd pretty get that.
Yeah.
That's actually, fuck.
You know, cranberry flavored stuff is actually really good.
Yeah, I'm taking that home with me. A little Ziploc bag, fantastic.
Should we talk about some of the stuff at the front here?
Okay, yeah, I want to talk about this. I really like these. These are the ramune flavored, what is
candy?
Candy.
I have an ancient video on my channel from like 6 years ago where I bought like a box of those candy.
Right.
And I said to myself, would I be able to change ramune candy back to ramune? Was it this ancient video on my channel?
What is this, a Vsauce video?
Yeah. So what I did was I emptied out like 30 of these
into a
bowl.
Grease on there. No. Oh God.
I emptied like 30 of these into a bowl and I crushed them into a powder and then I mixed it with the carbonated water to see if it would go back into a ramune. Spoilers, it doesn't go back into a ramune.
I only ever had the drink a few times. It's quite nice, but I mean,
ramune is basically how would you describe ramune? It's basically like a Japanese lemonade, right?
Yeah, Japanese lemonade.
Wow. Yeah.
I love these. This.
You love this?
Dude, I grew up with this shit.
Yeah,
no, okay.
This is like eating a kid's
I eat this and I'm like, I taste a childhood I never had.
No wonder you look like 10 gone, because you're fucking eating kids shit all the time. Pretty, what, were you drinking like breast milk still all the time? Like, what's going on?
Like, I would eat this, what Connor has the right there, Choco Babies.
I love these. These
are great.
These are like, these are terrible though, because like, you think you're not eating a lot of chocolate, because it's so fucking dense.
Right? I look at this and I thought it was going to be a Tic Tac.
Right.
The first time I tried this, I thought it looks like a Tic Tac.
Yeah.
And then you bite into it and it's just pure chocolate. It's pure chocolate.
Good chocolate as well, though.
It's the most inoffensive chocolate that it's like, it's the good chocolate you would eat as a kid.
There's a tag at the bottom.
There was a tag.
That doesn't matter.
You did it.
Yeah, literally just Tic Tac chocolate version.
Yeah, pretty much.
It makes chocolate way too easy to eat because you just...
And the supermarkets have the big versions.
Yeah.
And if I get them, it's almost impossible not to eat
it. It's like eating sprinklings.
That's my childhood right there, lads.
Like this big as well. Tiny. Yeah.
That's my childhood
that's
right there.
That's really nice milk chocolate. That's good shit.
The other thing though that is my childhood is these things, umaibo.
I hate these. These suck.
Have you tried these?
No.
Oh yeah, you can try it.
Okay. So these, they're literally called umaibo, which means tasty stick. That's literally what it's called.
Okay.
And it's basically, oh God, how do you even explain it? So basically there's like, these have been around since like the fucking 20s. Like these are ancient and they're 10 yen each, right? Fucking nothing. But feel how light that is.
These are the space raiders. These are the space raiders of Japan, I think.
Yeah. This is packaged air.
Yeah. If you throw this high enough into the air, it'll just go off.
This has no weight at all.
What's the actual weight written on the package?
It
doesn't, 6 grams.
6 grams.
But I guarantee.
I'm pretty sure most of the grams is the packaging. It's the fucking packaging. I'm literally holding air here.
So I have the corn portage flavored, which is like corn soup.
Dude, this just looks like Monster's crisps.
I got the cheese one.
You should try it.
What is this flavor?
Those are the mentaiko flavor, the skodro.
This is just Monster's crisps, isn't it?
Monster's crisps if they were made by Space Raiders. Yeah. Do you have Space Raiders in Australia?
I've heard of those, yeah.
Oh,
all right.
That's right. It's a big Watsit.
It takes away all the moisture in your mouth.
Yeah, it's a Monster's crisp.
It's just a Watsit.
Yeah.
It's a big Watsit, man. This is cheese, it's just a Watsit. Mm.
Honestly, I mean, I can understand why that was your childhood.
Americans, this is a Cheeto.
I mean, honestly, dude, like, imagine, like, you're like a 5-year-old, right?
Yeah.
You're given like 100 yen of like, just, you know, pocket money from your grandma.
Of course you're buying 10 of these.
I'm buying 10 of these. Like, these motherfuckers are going to fill me up until dinner.
Honestly, I mean, who doesn't love fucking Watsits or Monster's Crisps or whatever?
just cheese sticks.
Oh, cheese, come on, yeah.
I can guarantee though that these are probably not the best tasting cheese.
Look, I also grew up with these, but after about age 8, I stopped eating them because I had proper cheese in Australia.
When you have real cheese, you can't eat this. No. But if you're American and not from Wisconsin.
But this is not just cheese. This is cheese with kamaboko, which is fish cake.
You shouldn't have said that. You should have let him try it.
You just give it a go.
You want to try it, Garl?
Sure.
You're on the show. You can't say no anymore.
I can't say no. I'm actually really
Look at that.
What the fuck is this?
What the fuck?
What?
Come on.
How the hell do I describe
I've never had one of these.
How do you eat these, Joey?
I'm going to be honest. This is probably the least appetizing looking thing that we've had on today.
Oh,
you kind of just rip it open like that.
We've had some pretty gross shit, but this looks vile. This actually looks disgusting.
This looks like on the same level as squirt.
What's the ratio of cheese to like fish?
You don't want to smell them.
How do I open this?
This immediately just like grab the top and just like that like a banana. These boys are struggling. Here, here, I'll open them up for you. There you go. I'll
okay, let me get the.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Knife.
There you go. Just get a knife. There
we go. Oh, okay.
Fucking hell. Yo, Fort Knox should be.
This actually smells close to vomit, I think. As close to vomit
it's
as
like
you can possibly.
It's like cheesy vomit, isn't it?
Yeah, that's yeah. it.
All right, I'm gonna have one because I haven't
have
had these.
It?
Yeah,
smell it.
I haven't had one of these since I was about 8.
Okay, is this gonna be cheese flavored vomit like I imagine it to be?
Yeah, it tastes exactly how I remember it.
Oh.
Boomer tries Japanese snack for first time.
Honestly, it doesn't taste as bad as I thought it would.
No.
It tastes like you're eating plastic.
Yeah.
It tastes like you're eating plastic and then you get the fish aftertaste. Yep. The That's fish exactly.
aftertaste. Where is the cheese in that? I don't taste any.
That
fucking
was not
cheese.
That was plastic.
No.
That's
a plastic fish sausage.
That's fish. That's fish flavored plastic.
I have a melty kiss, as they're called.
Meruti kiss.
Meruti kiss, as they say in all the commercials.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't particularly like these.
You don't?
It's just mochi, right? What have you mochi?
Yeah, it's like mochi with like chocolate on it.
Yeah. Well, let's give it a shot, shall we?
You're not a fan of mochi?
Mochi's hit or miss for me.
Of course, because it's Japan, like they're individually packaged.
Yeah. Love the packaging.
Say what you will. It's fucking pretty. Like the box makes you want to get
it. The thing about Melty Kiss is one of those brands in Japan that is always seasonal. They always have a seasonal flavor of Melty Kiss. You can tell what time period you are in when you go to a supermarket or a konbini and you see what Melty Kisses are on for
and
sale.
As the name suggests, they melt pretty fucking fast.
Yeah. So I really like it. It's...
I like them.
It is just basically mochi with chocolate. It's just basically.
I fuck with that.
Actually, you know what? That's really good.
Yeah. I don't know what Melty Kiss you had.
I think I had an awful like tasting one. This is just chocolate. This is fucking good.
This is chocolate truffle.
This is really rich
it's
chocolate.
Just, it's just chocolate truffle, chocolate. Right?
There's no mochi in this, is there?
Yeah.
Is there?
I think so.
There might be a mochi variant.
Oh, I thought it was mochi. So I tasted that. I didn't taste any mochi.
It's like a truffle.
That's just chocolate.
I think that's just the truffle
right,
part
I
of the
I fuck
chocolate.
With that, and thank God they're all individually wrapped, so we can enjoy those later.
Yeah.
I also have this is mochi.
That's
though.
The mochi.
That's
yeah,
mochi.
Sorry.
What is this? Mochi mochi. Oh my God, I can't read fucking the font.
Come on, you're Nihongo Josu. You can do it.
Shiora.
So sure you're just trying to, no. But they're trying to figure it out,
bro. It's the fancy fonts fuck me up in Japanese so
it's
much.
Shokora.
Oh, that's Ko. Oh, okay.
that looks like a U, doesn't it?
I thought that was a U as
I
well.
I thought it was a U as well.
U would be U. The bottom would be
yeah,
bold.
Yeah.
No,
because I
was. Remember it. I remember.
It's got a little bit there. I thought
yeah,
that
I remember
was
the
no,
U. That's, it that's looks fancy. Like an iron, and, yeah, and yeah. that kind of looks
like an iron.
That's how I remember the U. It looks like an iron.
That's cute. So it's separated into cute little packages.
Oh, cute. So dude, that's like perfect for dates.
Yeah.
Man. You and your GF rocking up with
okay,
them.
Okay, how do you feel about mochi?
Mid tier.
It depends. It depends on the type. Like mochi ice cream and like regular mochi and like sweet mochis is like completely different in my opinion.
Yeah, so what is mochi again?
Mochi is just rice. It's rice pudding.
Yeah, so mochi is just rice pudding.
So basically they grab mochi rice, which is a specific type of rice, mm-hmm. and they just fucking mash it with a hammer until it turns into mochi.
That's good.
It's very chewy. It's
just good shit.
Yeah.
That's clean.
How I always feel about mochi is that it's just very inoffensive. I would never not eat mochi, but I would never go out of my way to get it as
but
well.
But you know, like a lot of old people die from choking on mochi.
I can see why.
Yeah. So when you eat mochi,
shit
make sure you're
back.
Like, yeah, make sure you like properly chew this shit. Otherwise it will get stuck in your throat.
I'm sorry, I was laughing because I saw one of Garnt's item. I keep forgetting it's called this. It's called the chocolate pound cake. For some reason, that feels so. That is such a sexual energy.
That
to
is
it.
Like a. I never thought about that. I was like, yeah, pound cake, of course. But when you say it in English,
when
it's really
like,
weird.
That's the chocolate pound cake.
Yo, girl.
Chocolate
pound. Yo, girl, cake. You want to get some chocolate pound cake?
That feel. Yeah. See that. Yeah. That has like that. I've never had a food item that has raw sexual energy, but that has it.
I mean, this. Hey, yo, shawty. Yo, want a chocolate pound cake?
What that pound cake do?
Honestly, I mean, it's just cake. I don't.
It's just a fat. Block of chocolate. Yeah, I'll fuck with that.
Yeah,
that's.
I mean, I know what this tastes like.
Yeah, I know what this tastes
like. Yeah, Gaunt, when Gaunt has run out of energy, he'll run into the 7-Eleven or like Family Mart and just buy one of these and
yeah,
just
I don't know how you do that. To be honest.
So sometimes I just need a sugar rush. I don't know.
It's just a brownie.
Yeah, it literally just tastes like a brownie. Yeah,
I mean, it's just a brownie.
I don't need to describe that.
But it's way more sexually sounding than a brownie. Yeah. A pound cake.
Pound cake does sound better than brownie.
Yeah.
Hold up the camera. That's nice, right?
Yeah.
That's not bad.
That's sexy.
Mm.
All right, I think we are almost done, right?
Jerry, what do you have?
I've got these like chocolate pies. Choco pie.
Oh God, no.
Yeah.
That just looks like a pain de chocolat.
Yeah, but like not as good.
France is crying right now.
I don't really fuck with these, to be honest.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest. I don't need to try that.
Yeah, honestly, I don't need to try that. Let's not open that.
Let's open the stuff that is like only-
What is that, like God? The fuck is that Kit Kat?
This is a melon Kit Kat.
You're kidding me. Why?
Because melon Kit Kat?
They have, yeah, like a-
That's a Hokkaido melon Kit Kat too. That's the good melons.
Ooh.
See, the thing about like Hokkaido melons is that it is expensive as fuck here. Yeah. Because apparently it tastes fucking super amazing.
Hokkaido melons for preference, like one of like, maybe about that big, but a regular thing will cost you like $200-$300. It's like the top class of melon.
Whoa.
Oh, this is the ball variety that we tried before.
Yeah. Is this just gonna taste like Kit Kat again?
Whoa.
I fuck with that. I love melon flavored shit.
Oh shit, that's good.
Yeah.
That is good.
That's really good.
Oh my God.
That might be one of the best ones I've tried.
Yo, that's fun. Yo.
Hey, give me some of that.
That's probably the best Kit Kat I've ever had in my life.
That is such a clean flavor to it. Like
that straight up tastes like you're eating a melon.
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
It's like the crunchiness of a biscuit and a Kit Kat, but with the clean taste of a fruit.
Mm. Wow.
I can't.
That's like, really good.
Wow.
Mm. You know how you bite into a melon and it just-
God damn.
You know how you bite into a melon and it just like, it feels like clean because it feels like you're eating like a really watery fruit.
Yeah.
For some reason, that was a completely dry snack that we just had,
but it felt watery.
It felt watery.
Yeah, yeah.
What the fuck is this? Sugar butter sand tree.
We don't need to try that.
It's called sugar butter sand tree.
What the fuck is that?
It's just like a custard
cream. Oh, it's a 7-Eleven brand too.
Yeah. Fuck that. I have wasabi sticks, it looks like. Is that cheese and wasabi?
No, that's jagariko, which is like a brand of like savory sticks. Literally and I guess this is a wasabi shoyu flavored.
Right?
Do you like wasabi snacks?
No.
I do not get them.
I like the wasabi like beans. The wasabi seed, like mm-hmm. flavor things. I forgot what they were called, but like.
I know what you're talking about.
It's like the peanut and
yeah,
like
there's,
wasabi.
Yeah, there's like beans that are covered in wasabi.
Yeah, I fuck with those. Let me smell this.
I don't know.
Boy.
For me, wasabi just doesn't feel like something that should be snacked on. That's basic as fuck.
Did you taste anything?
I don't taste anything.
I taste the wasabi, yeah.
I barely oh, a little bit, tiny bit.
Oh yeah, there it
because
is.
Because when we eat something wasabi flavor, we're used to the whole like kickback, right? But this is just like literally just a hint of wasabi flavor.
That's so
good. Honestly?
It's not too overpowering.
Honestly,
I like that.
Fuck yes. Mm. I literally was just shitting on wasabi snacks literally 5 minutes ago. And that's because the wasabi, normally what happens with wasabi snacks is that it overpowers whatever you're eating. Good.
Like and I can properly taste the soy sauce in that as well.
Yeah, and like I ate that and I was like, I can't even taste the wasabi. But then you get that aftertaste.
And you literally just did like the kombucha girl, like. Mm-hmm. You're like, no, wasabi. Actually, these are pretty good.
Yeah, because you know when you have bad sushi and then you kind of like try to overpower it with wasabi just to get rid of the taste of the bad sushi.
Who does that? Do you do that?
Sometimes. Sometimes. Like really, but like I don't find myself in a bad sushi restaurant. I know where a good one.
No.
But Joey was Louis. He didn't go into a bad sushi
restaurant. I don't go to that 100 yen bullshit sushi.
You go to some sushi restaurants, especially with friends from abroad, and you see them like put a little bit of soy sauce and then fucking wasabi.
Yeah.
And then it's like 90% wasabi, 10% soy sauce, and they just basically just dip the entire sushi in the wasabi.
They
fucking drown it in, and I don't know how they can taste the fish.
That's the incorrect way to eat sushi.
Yeah.
Finally, go on.
And I feel like this is the perfect kind of balance of like how a good sushi should taste like.
I really like those, actually.
Damn, when's the Giga video coming on about these? you went on a fucking rant there about how beautiful they were. But final thing we have is
matcha.
Classic.
Matcha.
We could have had about a bazillion matcha items we wanted to, I think.
Honestly, I think matcha is my favorite kind of
Weren't you the guy like 7 months ago who thought matcha was overrated?
I don't think so.
No, I don't think that was gone. It was someone else.
Gone?
It was someone else.
I think Matcha's overhyped.
I feel that's like the two.
Okay, so you're the guy who think Matcha's overhyped.
I think Matcha's also overhyped.
I feel that's
overhyped.
The two dichotomies with Matcha, though. It's either you think it's fucking amazing with everything, or you think it's overrated as fuck.
I think it's great. Stuff. I mean, in the last podcast we recorded, I had a Matcha Latte.
To me, Matcha is kind of like, sometimes I'll eat one, it's like handing a cigarette over.
All right, let's fucking try it.
Gentlemen.
I've had these before. These are great.
Yeah, these are great.
I mean, it's fine.
Matcha snacks are great.
I'd rather a chocolate-based thing.
Honestly, one question. Have you ever had matcha soft serve?
Yeah.
Because matcha soft serve is literally the single-handedly changed my opinion of matcha. Because after I had matcha soft serve, I'm like, matcha tastes fucking great.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we have more, sorry. I forgot. Okay. We have this thing, which is gohan desu.
Nihongo Josu.
Gohan desu.
Gohan desu, which is basically this, like, I don't even know what the flavor of it is. It's just gohan desu flavored, but basically you put it on a bed of rice and it basically, it's good on rice. That's all it is.
Bruh, you're kidding me.
Can I smell that?
That smells like seaweed.
It's a seaweed paste.
Okay.
But you would give this to like kids.
I think I inhaled an X amount of salt just from being near that.
Well, that's the thing. Because it's so salty, you put that on a bed of rice and it mellows it out perfectly.
I'm not going to eat that.
I'm not eating
that. This is Jaga Choco. And it's just potato chips, it looks like, to be-
With chocolate.
Which is chocolate. It looks like
chocolate
it's-
Chocolate potato chips.
Looks like it hasn't been- you know what, fuck it. I can make assumptions all day. As the great Lord says, let's just jump right into it. Oh, okay.
Okay, that's-
I think I've tried these before.
Looking a little anemic, dare I say.
I mean, it's literally just a chocolate potato chip.
Will it be salty though? That's what I'm curious about.
Yeah. They are weirdly salty.
You can't taste the chocolate. There's too much salt.
I'm having a kombucha tea moment right now.
It's like, not gonna lie.
No.
That's a little too much salt for me.
A little too much.
You know what that tastes like? It tastes like you ate a bag of crisps and then you instantly downed it with like a hot chocolate.
If I'm gonna-
That's what that tastes like.
Get double calories of eating crisps and chocolate, I wanna enjoy both, right? Exactly. I don't wanna like have one and then just eat calories for no fucking reason.
I gotta cleanse my palate with this.
What is that
I'm having
Joe?
An existential moment.
What's that polar bear thing you have?
It's basically, what the fuck is this? Konayuki Shokora. This is basically Melty Kiss, I think.
Oh.
Kind of the same thing.
It's crack like, it open. Let's try it out.
It's like a brownie, I guess. Let's try it
this
out.
This is giving me an existential crisis right now.
Just keep eating it.
Oh, they're big.
Whoa.
Look at the packaging it comes in, dude. That's fancy as fuck.
Whoa, what is that?
I don't know. Let's crack it open, though.
Gaunt, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay.
It's not good, Gaunt. Why are we deciding if it's good or not?
Because it tastes good, and then it doesn't, and then it does, and then it doesn't, and then it... I'm so fucking confused.
It's like a Melty Kiss, but kind of more fancy looking. Just grab one. Just pop it out. There you go. It's like a mini brownie.
Whoa.
Oh, it's not like a mini brownie.
Whoa, it's like if snow was chocolate.
Actually, it says powder snow chocolate. There you go. The branding on point.
Man, that's so rich.
That instantly melts away.
Holy fuck.
You want to try that?
Hold on.
You're still having an existential crisis with that one?
I think I like this.
Really?
It took me 3 bites.
After much deliberation,
I didn't hear whatever you guys were talking about because I was true.
Guys, he likes it.
I was just trying to figure out if this was a taste that I like and- It was like
having like an ancient Greek like philosophy like Aristotle moment in his head while we were eating this.
So what is it that you're talking about? What is this?
This is powder snow chocolate. It literally just melts away.
What is that? I don't know.
This man can't make up his mind. It's better. Anything.
This honestly has fucked me up because I'm just like, do I like things now? What do I like anymore? What is life?
Oh god, I feel sick.
I don't eat chocolate, but this is more chocolate than I've had in so long.
This is, I remember how we were debating if we were gonna have dinner after filming this episode.
We are not having dinner after filming this episode.
I just enjoy the atmosphere of having a dinner together. This
is not a dinner with the boys. You literally just witnessed 3 people have dinner together.
Over 2 hours.
Yeah, for 2 hours.
A literal combini dinner. And
so
it was,
lads, like, what would you say is your favorite, I guess, item from each genre of food?
It's So you're saying the hot foods first?
Yeah, so hot foods, which one ranks supreme in the hot
foods? Okay, hot food, I'm still standing seven. Seven if Lawson you want a meal.
Lawson fried chicken. Lawson fried chicken, man.
Seven fried chicken, seven beef bowl, seven any hot food.
Nah, honestly, I think Lawson have been doing the hot food better, man. Gotta be real with you, man.
If I'm going to be the mediator, I would have to just give it to seven.
You fucking yes! eat for real? You fucking
yes!
For real?
Yeah, I'd have to just give it to seven. You're not a clown, Joe.
You're the whole circus.
Again, I don't eat the fried food, so I don't fucking care. All we know is that Family Mart fried food sucks ass.
I never get the fried food from the company because I'm just like,
if I'm going to have fried food, I'm going to go to a fucking restaurant.
Yeah, if I'm going to fuck up my body, I'm going to do it in a good place.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Pay good money to fuck up your body.
I want the best shit if this is like my cheat day, right?
Yeah.
What about the best like sandwiches then?
Oh, sandwich.
Probably Lawson's.
Have I converted you into seeing the way of the tuna sandwich from Lawson's?
I mean, look, the tuna sandwich is Lawson is definitely better, but egg sandwich, Family Mart's better.
If only they could join forces.
Yeah, yeah, I would agree with that.
If only they could join forces.
Like runny egg sandwiches should never be a thing.
It's not runny.
I don't know about that.
It's a paste. It's mashed up.
It's the collab we want to happen.
Japan, we're waiting.
Like egg paste shouldn't be a thing. It's
not paste. It's mashed down.
I want to taste the egg slices.
I want the texture.
I don't need it.
I need it.
Like even
I prefer it. I prefer
even
it,
even scrambled egg has a texture. This was like scrambled egg that was put into a paste. It is.
I like
it. It's like egg flavored glue. That's what it tastes like.
To me, the egg is like, they're both very strong. Mm. But to me, the tuna is just so much better.
The tuna is hands down better.
It's like, why would I want it? And also like there's supermarkets that like aren't any of those that get like the sandwiches as well. And the tuna always tastes like the Family Mart one for some reason.
Yeah, for some reason,
just Lawson's.
I feel the Lawson one, they actually took like the canned tuna and just
put it in. Yeah, it's good shit. It's good fucking shit.
I feel like the Lawson's one, the tuna sandwiches is definitely better. The egg sandwiches, Family Mart were definitely better. I don't eat that many sandwiches from the combinis, so I don't really have too much of a strong opinion.
What about the onigiri, the rice balls?
Lawson's.
Yeah, Lawson's hands down.
Lawson's hands down.
Of a sample size of one type.
Yeah.
I did not realize though that because we saw 2 7 onigiris. I don't know if one will make it to the final cut, but we opened up two. They both looked as depressing as each other. My God.
Yeah, they're pretty sad.
The Lawson one was clean. Yeah. It was nicely wrapped around.
That was an art piece right there.
And the fillings were in every single bite. That's no matter where I bite, I need to get a bit of filling.
Yeah, absolutely.
Lawson's hit it on the mark.
Lawson's definitely by far the best onigiri.
Thank you guys. Thank you. Appreciate the love.
What about what else did we cover? I guess snacks?
We had fish snacks, meat snacks.
I mean, the fish snacks and meat snacks, I think we can all agree, are all pretty mid.
Yeah, they're all like the same level.
They're all the same.
Oh no, I like the fish crisps.
The Lawson fish crisps. Yeah.
I think that the way that Lawson's do the squid as well is really fucking good.
Yeah, yeah. We unfortunately didn't get to try any like dried squid or dried fish or something, but it's something that a lot of people from, you know, America and England that I've met have, because I bring this shit from Thailand to England and people are like, why are you eating fish food? it kind of does smell a bit like fish food.
A little bit, it does,
but it tastes fucking awesome. Yeah. It's the perfect amount of salty. It's perfect to go with your beer.
Absolutely.
Fish snacks just, you don't know the full enjoyment of fish snacks until you've had a cold beer with them.
You gotta have a beer with them. I don't know why, I must say,
I'm thoroughly impressed with the one cup personally. I thought I was gonna fucking hate this. I finished it.
I'm impressed.
Yeah. I thought it was gonna taste like shit and it tasted not great, but drinkable. But way better than Chris's. Yeah. So I would
buy another one of these.
What the fuck did Chris just bring us like the
expired
budget?
Sake. Yeah,
the worst one he could find.
He's just like pissed in a bottle. He's like, yeah, sake, trust me.
It's so potent. It has alcohol in it. My favorite snack, I think it's gotta be the Kit Kat. Watermelon, the Kit Kat.
Yeah, the Kit Kat watermelon.
You mean the melon, just the rock melon, right?
The Kit Kat melon.
The melon
Kit Kat. Yeah.
That was.
I also really like these though.
I like them, but I think the Kit Kat melon was just above the rest.
And then obviously
all the breads
like,
disappointed me.
Yeah, the breads were kind of mid.
This though.
No, it's not.
Let me just.
Choco babies, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, and again, like, you know, like the ramune and stuff like that, the choco baby stuff that I grew up with, this shit's great.
You're having another existential
crisis right now?
Fuck, I took a bite and I was just like, this tastes awful. And then I'm just like, no, this tastes good.
You gotta fucking try this. Please try this.
You don't have to.
Okay, no, I got it.
The initial taste tastes fucking awful.
Right.
And then the aftertaste kicks in and I'm like, this tastes like a what does taste? The aftertaste gives me the same kind of taste that I, when you're cooking like a brownie or something and you have like cooking chocolate, and you're cooking like a chocolate pudding, and then as a kid you kind of just like have a bit of the chocolate, you know.
It doesn't taste.
You scoop
like
a bit into your mouth.
Not gonna lie, I wasn't like listening. I was just enjoying Connor looking dead over there.
It doesn't taste like that. You're chatting shit.
But all in all, I'd have to say, you can get like this.
You're
is
a
not
winner.
Even
you're a winner if you're in Japan.
This is not even all of yeah, this is not even a corner of what you can get at a konbini.
Fuck the best tasting thing. What was the worst tasting thing?
Oh God.
Okay. Because I'm having a hard time deciding between this and this.
No, honestly, the crab cake. The crab cake.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the crab cake was
crab
pretty
cake
bad.
Was the
no,
worst.
Actually, it's this for me. This has the worst aftertaste in the crab cake. I still have the aftertaste of this in my mouth right now after eating all that.
Shit was gross.
Yeah, cheekama. I mean, I grew up with cheekama, and there's a reason why I stopped eating it because it's gross.
It ain't right. It ain't right.
It literally smells like vomit.
Yeah, it ain't right. Oh, that was probably the worst flavored one.
That was the worst thing.
But yeah, again, like this is nowhere near the variety that you can get at a convenience store, right? Like there's so many more snacks. I mean, you know, haven't even talked about the fact that, you know, you can buy basically fucking anything at a convenience store,
you can
right?
Pay like your utility bills.
You can pay
packages.
Your rent at a konbini.
Yeah, you can send packages.
You can get toiletries. You can get, you know, like-
Lawson's next to me has now basically just has a whole section for like household items. So like you can buy like bed sheets and like soap containers.
Yeah.
And like weird shit that you're like, why do I need this here? It's like a mini IKEA in Lawson's. It's so strange, but really cool.
You can buy stuff like, you can buy technical stuff like SD cards.
Like chargers and stuff like
deodorant,
that. I bought underwear from
I have a pair of, honestly, the best pair of socks I've bought in Japan were from Lawson's.
From Lawson's.
They're really fucking.
Honestly, I have gloves, like hand gloves that I bought from Family Mart and I still wear them to this day.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
So super, super convenient. So like definitely when you come to Japan, whenever the world opens up,
Let us know what your favorite is.
Yeah, let us know what your favorite is. Yeah. It might be neither of our things, right? It could be Ministop. It could be Yamazaki. Who knows?
And let Chris Broad know that his shit tasting that Family Mart chicken is the best.
Family Mart chicken is not the best.
That's the real loser here.
Yeah. The real loser is the fact that Chris thinks that Family Mart chicken
tastes
good.
If you come to Japan, please go to Family Mart chicken, Family Mart, get the chicken and just, you know, validate our opinion. Yeah.
Please be disappointed.
Fucking awful. Yeah.
Also, let us know if you enjoyed this episode, which is a very different format to our usual.
Yeah. We just kind of wanted to try this out to kind of, you know, give you guys something a little bit different than just us chatting shit for 2 hours.
Yeah, we were just experimenting.
Which we will get back to very shortly.
Yeah, absolutely. But in the meantime, look at all these patrons.
Wow, look at this guy here.
Look at that guy and that guy.
He hates Family Mart chicken.
This guy doesn't eat crab cakes with cheese.
But yeah, if you guys would like to support us, make sure to go to patreon.com/trashtaste. Also, send us your memes on Twitter, the subreddit, and listen to us on Spotify. Maybe not this episode. Don't listen to this episode.
No,
a bit late if you got this far on the
We warned you right at the beginning. But every other episode, you can probably listen to on Spotify.
Apologies to any audio-only listeners who have attempted to get through this episode.
They're just like imagining what everything looks like. It's like...
They probably had a nice like 2 hour eating ASMR.
Yeah, it's just a lot of like chewing.
World's slowest mukbang.
God, but yeah, guys.
I'm exhausted from eating so much.
Yeah. I actually-
God,
like,
stop.
I want like a proper meal. So let's just go do that. All right, guys. Thanks for enjoying this strange episode. We'll get back to your regularly scheduled program soon. But in the meantime, have a good one. Bye. Stop eating them.
No, I don't like it.